bigger in person.
I know, he's a man's man.
What's your actual fucking name?
I had a lunchbox that was more of a purse. Long.
God damn, this is soft.
Dave and Sas butt heads. Oh, yeah.
He stole the term numbies from me.
Sas is so skinny and white that Jelly Roll might try and snort him.
You should fight Bryce Hall. Your boys are my boys.
Damn. It kind of sucks.
Lacrosse is gay.
Sas, what's up, bro?
How's it going?
It's going well.
Yeah?
I'm excited to have you on.
Thank you. I'm excited to be here.
Are we rolling? Yep, we
are. I tried to tell him he has to talk like a football player. I said that's all he understands.
Have you ever played football?
No. I mean, I've played like... Me and Rone toss the rock around occasionally.
We tried to bring a football on like the road trips just to, you know what I mean, get the to jog the mind.
Take him to the Philly tailgates?
We did. We took a football out there. We took it to the Penn State tailgate. We just taught, dude, he could have been a quarterback.
Yeah, I got a great arm.
How was the Philly tailgates? How was the Philly atmosphere?
Oh, it was
I'll
fun.
Let you speak on it.
I thought the Penn State one was fun. We were doing a lot more recording there though.
Filming stuff?
Yeah, filming shit. But the Eagles one was really fun, too.
Scumbags? Yeah. A lot of scumbags? How would you characterize the
temperature
of the people? No, I
wouldn't say scumbags.
No? You wouldn't?
No.
He didn't mean
I know that's
people.
Like a known thing that they're scumbags, but
who?
Like the Eagles fans.
So you wouldn't say Eagles fans are scumbags?
I wouldn't then. No, I didn't meet any scumbags. Everyone seemed very nice.
Dude, I think it's because we were close to it's like the nucleus of the atom. Like the closer you are to the stadium, like the richer people are, the more like refined people are. We weren't out on the outskirts. We're like the true scumbags are.
The true scumbags are.
We also went
But did you go to the game?
No, we didn't even go into the game.
Fuck.
In the game, it's disgusting. There's like the story about the one kid who would like intentionally throw up on like someone else's child or something like that.
Jesus.
It's like the most vile Philly fan of all time. One time they said that it was like a cold ass game and like it was like a woman was like freezing. She looked down and there was just a dude sucking on her toe. Just a stranger sucking her toe. I don't even know how her toe was
just
exposed.
Just for some like some good luck shit?
I don't even know, dude.
Like Silver Linings Playbook? Where he wants him to hold it. He wants him to sit in a certain spot and hold the paper the right
maybe
way.
Maybe that's what it was. Maybe that was, they did win the Super Bowl that year. So maybe that they just had to keep on sucking that toe.
Philly's like my favorite place to play because they hate you so much. But if you're on the other, if you're like a fan of the other team, like my wife, she's there and she was wearing the Washington gear and they're like, fuck you, bitch. And throwing ass cans at her.
What?
Like, yeah, I'll take a beer. And right when they get the beer, they just fucking throw it at her.
Wow.
Just that's crazy. Shit. Yeah. I think I would just not wear the jersey at that point.
Just go incognito.
Yeah.
Just wear the NFL hat.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. The Rob Lowe hat.
Do you have an NFL team?
Patriots, if I had to pick. I mean, I'm from Massachusetts.
Okay.
Yeah.
Dude, he doesn't care about sports at all. It's fucking crazy. And that's why it's awesome
to
have
him
in here.
Why are you wearing a Mississippi State shirt then?
One of my buddies gave it to me. I like hockey. Hockey is the only sport I've ever paid attention to. I don't pay attention to the normal season, but once they go to the playoffs, I do.
Name five hockey players.
Okay, well, that's hard if you're going to make if you're gonna put
let's
me
say
on
of
like,
all time.
You're going to put me on the spot like that.
You just said you follow it.
I think I could name five current hockey players.
You just don't want
to. Start it up.
Just don't want to. Were you about to say Pavel?
I was going to say Patrick Kane, but does he still play?
Probably. That works. I'm not a hockey. You could get past it on me and him. I'm not a hockey guy either.
Ovechkin,
Sidney Crosby.
There you go. Start with the superstars.
Tuukka Rask.
Okay. And one more. Land the plane.
Patrice Bergeron.
Okay, let's go.
See, I feel like we got a fact check.
Because I don't think any of those guys retired.
He's a hockey buff.
Can we bring up the Chevy ad? I forget we got to do that within the first 5 minutes.
You got to rip it. Yo, by the way, while they're bringing that up, what neighborhood are we in right now? Are we in a Venezuelan neighborhood?
Well, what neighborhood is this? Berry Hill? Are we in like the Berry Hill?
It's very Venezuelan. There's like a Venezuelan restaurant right across the street. We tried to go in and get some coffee somewhere.
Really weird. Really weird.
When
place.
You said that and you're like, we can be there within 5 minutes, I was like, oh, they're around here.
We kind of were. Like,
we were like 1 minute away.
Yeah, we were very close. But we went to what we thought. It came up on Google Maps as a coffee place. We got in there and it was like a doctor's office when we walked in. They led us to a back room and there was like six people sitting at a bar. And they told us they don't have coffee, but all they have is like hot, really hot tea, and that people were drinking it out of 32 like, ounce styrofoam containers, just fucking crushing hot teas at a bar in the middle of a day.
Like, and I think everyone at the bar works there, I'm pretty sure, too.
Yeah, like it was like a wellness
facility. We asked like the menu, and everyone turned and was like, hot tea.
It was wild.
Yeah.
We left because I was, I didn't want hot tea, and that's like all they had. They looked at us like we were idiots for coming into this health clinic to not get hot tea. It's bizarre.
And you're just trying to show Sas Rone Nashville.
I was trying to show him a good time. I was like, we're going to get some hot chicken later on. We're going to, you know, go on the tour. We're going to do all these nice things. And we got off on the wrong foot, I think. We just went to the wrong spot. It's no one's fault.
Are you guys, did you guys get a rental?
We got a rental. We got a
Chevy Silverado.
We were trying to get
a Chevy Silverado. You got the Chevy Silverado.
We were trying to. They're out of, everyone must have them already because they were out of stock.
Do you know why?
Why?
Because the Silverado is strong, advanced, dependable, hardworking, like Sas. He's starting his comedy tour. Mm. He's starting his comedy bits. I checked it out. Hardworking, dependable. A strong football season calls for the strongest, most advanced Silverado ever. The available multi-flex tailgates with six convenient configurations will give you a step up on your tailgate game. Here's why, Sasco.
That's facts. Talk about it. He's been tailgating. You've been tailgating, Sas.
Here's why. You lost me at the
He's highlighted. It's highlighted.
There's the primary tailgate, which opens with a push of a button of the key. Wait.
It's all right. Taylor does worse than this. You're good.
There's the primary tailgate, which opens with a push of a button on the key I can't
fob.
Read that.
Key fob.
Or from inside the truck. The inner gate folds to a large step for easily getting in and out of the bed. There's an easy access configuration where the inner gate folds down, allowing you to reach farther into the bed. But
it can also become a desk or a surface for your tailgating meal. If you want to play a fun tailgating game, like smashing a nail into a stump, you could do that right in the back of your Chevy Silverado because it's built for that kind of shit. The hauling on that thing, absolutely unbelievable. Modern, advanced, a ton of grit. And they're a partner for you guys that just get, they just man.
I almost cursed right there. I almost cursed.
I did.
Did you curse?
I did.
It's all right. We get to bleep it out. We bleep. Chevy, they're respectable. They want us to be clean.
Yes. You know what I mean? I respect that.
Go to a Chevy dealership near you. Let them know that the boys sent you. Let them know that Sas and Rone, they came in, you know, son of a boy, dad. They'll hook you up with a free trailer hitch.
Yes.
As we're told, the strongest, most advanced Silverado yet.
Yes, let's go. They have the push to start. The car that they gave us is key to start. And I haven't seen one of those in like 18 years.
Did you know how to work it?
Where you actually have to insert the key in? Yeah. Luckily, I fiddled around a little bit and got it. Sas wouldn't have known how.
I was going to say, do you even know?
Rone was legitimately like that? Angry that there was no push to start.
Because rappers are still rapping about it like it's a new thing. They're like, no keys, push to start. It's like every fucking car has that. Yeah. Every single car. And then the one that we get doesn't have it. I was incensed. I was furious. I almost gave it back.
You're like, where the fuck is the push to start at?
I want the push to start, dude. I'm not trying to be turning the key like I'm starting the Model T Ford or something like
that.
Yeah,
you're not poor.
I'm not poor. Yeah. It's on the company dime. Barstool's not poor, more importantly.
Yeah.
Look at your guys' setup. No, there's nothing poor around here.
I know, thanks to Barstool. Hey, shut up, Barstool.
This is an incredible setup. Why is your podcast so much nicer looking than every other podcast?
Yeah.
Buddy, you're seeing this now. You didn't see the dog days.
Yeah.
You didn't see
You got it out the mud?
Oh, bro. We were out in a gravel parking lot when we found this bus, and we did our first episodes out there.
Really?
Before the AC, before, like, we're sitting out in the 98-degree weather during training camp.
So you earned it. You're 100-plus deep.
Yes. Look, check out the boys. It's our first one. That couch wasn't even there. We just had some busted chair, some hand-me-down.
That's classic.
But then it got too hot, so we had to buy tarps to put over the bus so it kept the light out, so it kept the sun out.
It still looks cool, though. It's like an aesthetic, at least. Nobody at Barstool has any aesthetic. None of the other podcasts. Chicks in the Office kind of has an aesthetic.
Because you guys just got rooms.
I mean, part of my any podcast with a studio does.
Yeah, they have a
KFC Radio, part of my take.
KFC Radio kind of does. Part of my take's just dumping shit into their office.
Yeah, they got theirs too messy.
It's not like a look.
Someone needs to clean that
thing
up.
It is very dirty in there.
They need to pass it on to a different podcast.
You're like kind of like stepping over stuff, yeah?
Yeah, son of a boy dad, we're taking it.
Yeah, why aren't you guys, why don't they set you guys up a little bit better?
I think it has something to do with lack of respect from the higher ups.
Which higher ups is there anybody thinking of specifically? Are we talking to Erica right now?
Most of them.
But mostly Dave and Sas butt heads.
Oh, yeah. We got a lot of problems.
Would it be fair to say he's nervous about the new guy?
Who's the new guy? You, oh, me. I'm the new guy.
Yes. Yeah. King of New York.
Yes.
No.
There's a lot of rumors out there saying, like, hey, he's going to be the next Portnoy. He's going to be the next face of
this
thing.
Yes. Yes. Exactly.
No, he stole the term numbies from me. So we've been.
You guys have been beefing.
We've had a falling out.
Every cool new term Sas gets, like, Dave steals it the next day.
He's throwing it on a t-shirt.
Sas came up with Saturdays Are For The Boys, and then like 2 weeks later, that was Sas. I swear to God, it was Sas.
I believe that. Yeah. I've heard that stuff.
I was in seventh grade, and I sent those in.
Are there numbies t-shirts?
I don't know if they're actually for sale. But like Dave probably just made one.
Once we started calling him out, maybe he stopped printing them.
He fell back.
Yeah, are you guys able to print those? Like, are you guys able to be like, hey, shoot up this fire merch?
I don't really even want it anymore.
No.
Now that it's stolen from Sas.
Stolen valor.
Yeah, exactly.
So now you guys got to come up with a different way to say numbies.
Rone has one.
Yes. Whenever we're about to do something. Whenever we're about to do some numbers,
yeah.
We start feeling cold in here, yeah. Start feeling a draft, you just look around when you know, and it's just like,
you're about to get the burrs.
We're about to do the burrs.
Is that because Son of a Boy Dad is becoming that popular?
I mean, it's on its way. Son of a Boy Dad is definitely, it's growing under the tutelage of Sas, and I'm just trying to, you know, I'm trying to put him in a position to succeed. I'm just trying to let him flourish out here.
Why does it seem like it's all about?
It isn't. Sas. Rone just says that when we're talking to people. We talk a completely equal amount on the show, and then Rone tells people he produces it.
It just puts me in a better spot. It like contextualizes it for people more. Like,
you feel like you're better if you kind of remove yourself. You like, you're a better hype man about it.
Yeah, I can kind of like, I'm like, oh, I just play the backseat or whatever, but I'm like reaching over him, like driving the wheel behind him, yeah, or whatever. But it seems easier if it's just like, I'm helping him start this podcast where he like navigates like the big bad streets of New York or whatever. It just like, they're like, we need a description for the show. It's like, okay, that's the description for the show. We'll run with it.
Now, are you trying to get to a point to where the training wheels come off and he's doing his own thing? Is that like the...
No, I hope not. Like,
hopefully, soon enough so I can move on to my next grooming victim.
Grooming victim.
Yeah, the next one that I'm trying... No, I'm trying to ride Sas till the wheels fall off, until he goes through like some kind of psychological breakdown or whatever.
Yeah.
Psychological breakdown.
Don't you think it's coming?
Soon.
I did hear... I listened to your stand-up.
Yeah.
I checked it out. It's doing well in the views. It's doing
we did well.
The YouTube verse. I appreciated it too, because I was driving over here and I saw a homeless guy standing on the side of the road and I called the cops immediately. we got him locked up.
We got a fresh one back here.
Like, right when I hung up, I'm like, oh, thank God for Sas, dude.
Fuck yeah.
Just round
them
up.
Need more of that.
With your comedy, are you like...
What?
Is it about to...
Yeah.
About to blow up?
Oh, probably not.
Like, you about to become the next in that too?
He is.
I mean, I would like to do more stand-up. It's not really about stand-up as much as it is live shows. Like, I just want to do live comedy.
What about live comedy? What do you want to do?
Like, we're doing Son of a Boy Dad live.
And so you just want to get like you want people there live to like laugh and applaud you. Basically,
yeah,
is what you're saying.
Pretty much, yeah.
Like, you're tired of it. Because we just do it to nobody in like a little closet with no aesthetic or whatever. It's like, we don't even know if people are laughing at this.
I know, we don't. It would be nice to hear people laugh.
Yeah. That's why we got five. That's why we have five of those dudes back there.
Yeah.
So you know when something hits, they all laugh and you're just feeling good about it.
Yeah, yeah.
It sets the vibe in a better direction, though. It's like it having like a little bit of a live studio audience. Like, you can kind of gauge what's working. Like, we'll just say shit and it's like, was that good? Or like,
yeah,
was that not good?
I think it's going to be fine. We got one on October 14th. Sold out, though.
Can't get your tickets.
Sold out.
So if you're listening,
sold out in 1 minute.
Sold out in 1 minute.
And we've been saying that, but it was only like 45 tickets. So it's like, yeah. One big party could have just bought them all up.
Where's it at?
It's just at a bar.
New York?
Yeah.
King of New York.
Then we got one coming up in Boston.
But
he's being humble. There are people. He's got like the suits coming out of the woodwork with like briefcases and pinstripes, trying to like be like, hey, like, we're going to make you some more money. He has people descending on him, trying to get a piece of the action.
Are you his agent?
No, I'm not even, but I'd like to be. I should at least be his agent for his agents.
Yeah.
And like,
right. Or a consultant.
They pay me, I'll take 10% off the top, and then he gets, you know, down the line, like he'll maybe right. get like
right.
five or 6% of everything.
Right. He'll be a country artist.
Yeah. Is that how they do them in town?
Yeah. Like everybody's got all the money. They find the voice, they find the figure, you know, big country is what they call it around here.
First time.
It kind of just takes over.
It's his first time in Nashville, so you got to tell him what to expect as far as the country artists, as far as like the live music scene, because we got off the plane, it was 10 in the morning, and there was somebody playing live music like right at the Chili's in the airport
or
whatever.
Yeah.
It's like that everywhere?
Pretty much. It's basically like if you go on Broadway, it's like a huge like alley of a theme park. You know how they have like the cotton candy and all the like decorative stuff at Disney World?
Yeah.
It's kind of the same thing, but country music.
Yeah, I'm pumped. One of my best friends goes to Vanderbilt, so... I'm seeing him today.
Yeah?
Yeah.
He's one of your best friends?
Yeah.
Does he come on visit you in New York?
Yeah, he has.
Okay, well, sounds like you guys are best friends.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I mean, there's so much stuff to do. I honestly live here.
Yeah.
I don't go out a whole lot.
Yeah.
So I can't sit here and tell you, oh, actually, Whiskey Row, it gets alive.
Where's that at?
Are you looking for loud? Are you looking for, like, I'm trying to be postured up in a corner next to an artist, like, I'm trying to flex on these dudes?
No, I'll probably start off the night slow, and then by the end, I'm looking to get loud.
He's going to get fired up.
What would you guys say? What would you guys recommend?
Breaking things.
Because we got some authentic Nashvillians here.
Don't start on Broadway.
You're right.
End of the night on Broadway?
We're going to start on Broadway.
Yes.
College atmosphere, younger crowd.
I'm a Kung Fu fan, or Kung Fu Panda fan. Kung Fu fan. Is it Kung Fu Panda or Kung Fu fan?
Kung Fu
Yeah,
Panda.
Kung Fu Saloon. I'm a fan of that because they got all the games and stuff. You can play a shot and, you know.
We got to swing through there for sure.
Yeah, I'm
pumped.
Right next to there's Losers, Winners and Losers Bar. That's a fire spot.
Yep. I think you told us about that a little bit last time.
You know the hot chicken. You've already done your...
We've done some hot chicken, but I got to bless him with some hot chicken.
Yeah, we're going to grab some hot chicken after this.
Bolton's wasn't open last time we were in town because Mr. Bolton had just passed away, unfortunately. So we got to roll through Bolton's.
So what's the difference between just like regular chicken sandwich and the hot chicken sandwich? Because I've never had like the hot chicken here and everyone always says get the hot chicken.
It's like a paste. It's like they basically a paste.
But like you said when you did it, they were just giving you like the hottest things that they could make.
Yeah,
when you say like hot, do you mean like it's super spicy?
Yes.
All right.
They're trying to...
I was literally on the plane. I was like, so do they mean spicy or do they just bring out like scalding hot?
Some like of those places, I don't get that either.
Yeah.
Like people come here, they're like, "Hey, let's get the Nashville chicken." And the cooks in the back are like, "How do we kill this dude?" Like that's how they'll remember.
Yes, we went to the place 400 degrees or whatever, and they gave us like the 1200 degree chicken or something like that. It was just painful. It wasn't like cool or fun. It was just like they were trying to hurt us.
Isn't that what they all did though?
A lot of them did. Yeah.
So there's a couple milder ones that you brought that tasted good.
Yes, those were fine, but you, like, in a strange stroke of fate, you got, like, the hottest one of all time.
Yeah, that was brutal.
Yeah, but
that
you were a tough. Fucking trooper. You weren't scared of it.
Yeah, I was grinding. We were already sweating. Like, we were already in a sauna.
We're going to try and get him out downtown, though. Sas is so skinny and white that Jelly Roll might try and snort him, but that's the kind of... we gotta get him mixed up with Jelly good. Roll out good. Here.
I tell you, you don't want to get mixed up with Jelly Roll.
No, we do want to get mixed up with Jelly Roll.
Bro, last time I was with Jelly, we were at... where were we at? Zany's. We're at Zany's. So when you guys do a show or do your live stuff or live comedy and stuff, you need to bring it through... You need to bring it through Zany's. I think Chicks in the Office is coming here.
Okay.
Zany's sounds familiar.
Yeah, Zany's is like, is it the only comedy club?
There's a couple. It's the main one.
Yeah, it's the main one that everybody goes to. But you like that vibe. But anyway, I was with Jelly. We stayed late at Zany's, and this dude's putting tequila shots in me left and right. And, you know,
it's
kind of my first time around him, so I'm like trying to like be, you know, be for the boys.
Keep up
with him.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then we got to the point of the night to where it just all felt like it hit me because I hadn't been drunk in a long time. Long time. And, bro, I remember telling my boy was in town, and I was like, Brad, I was like, hey, you got to get me out of here. And he was like talking to some gal, and I was like, a few minutes went by, and I'm just sitting at the bar by myself, kind of looking down, and it's all starting to get a little fuzzy for me. Like, I'm starting to sweat. It's starting to come up out of my pores.
Oh, my God.
Stuff. I'm like, I got to get home. And I grab Brad, I'm like, hey, we have to leave. And I'm like, I need your help walking out of here.
Yeah, you know like helps when you need out? His help. When you
Bro,
need to
yes.
rely on another human being to get you out
yeah.
of there.
Yeah, and he's driving me home. we're going back to my spot, and I'm like windows down, and I'm kind of just hanging on the side of the door, just praying. I'm literally just praying at this point that I don't throw up before I get home. And we'd stop at a stoplight. I don't know where we are. My eyes are just closed because I'm literally, again, just thinking, praying, like just
spinning.
Please save me. Yeah. And I'm like, go faster, but like don't go too fast type of thing.
No warp speed for
me. We get to the house, and I'm like, hey, I need you to take care of Waffle. And he's like, I got you. Waffle's my English bulldog.
Yeah.
Adorable. Scrumptious, dude. She's the best. And I just slowly walk up the stairs. It takes me probably 5 minutes to get up the stairs. I finally get to the bathroom, bro, and I just yak all over the place.
You did? You held it, though?
Oh, I held it. And then I'm like Team America yakking in the toilet.
Damn.
And I just fully clothed in bed out.
Damn.
Wake up the next day, little Waffle had shit all over the bed.
No way.
Oh, diarrhea. No.
No way. Why'd you blame it on Waffle? Why? You know you shit the bed.
At this point, I'm talking about how bad of a day it was. I wake up the next morning, I see like a shit stain going down the back of her ass.
Oh, no.
And she had diarrheaed all over the damn room, bro.
What?
And I'm talking Hangover City because of Jelly Roll. All the way to spin this back to Jelly Roll. Like, you got to be careful getting around that dude.
Yeah.
Because he's just, hey, Bubba.
Yeah, Bubba.
Take another one, Bubba.
Will do it on purpose to
bro.
You.
Bro. And you're just like, yeah, I fucking love Jelly.
And he's like an evil genius. He'll be like plotting in the corner, like tenting his fingers and stroking his beard. Like, yes, like get him fucked up. Like,
yeah,
because he
yeah.
did that to all my friends when they were in town too. Like,
yes,
he was
bro.
Just like bringing him into the bathroom or like, come over this way. Like, come down this way.
Hey, Bubba,
just,
here's another one.
Exactly,
it's like a double shot every
exactly.
time.
Exactly.
You're like, yeah, I got to show him how fucking hard I am.
Yeah,
like,
and it's
I
a go sport. Hard. And he's a big boy. Like, Sas doing the same amount of alcohol as Jelly Roll would like, kill Sas.
Yeah.
There's no doubt in my mind.
I went golfing with him later, like a few weeks later, and he was trying to get me hammered on the golf course. I'm like, hey, bro, I honestly.
You've
like,
learned your lesson.
Yeah, I can't do this again.
You've
you're bad
your
influence.
Lesson,
my
sure.
mom would tell me to stay away from you.
Rightfully so, but he's just a psychopath like that. I respect it. And I feel like there's a lot of people who just come to Nashville with that purpose, that they're just going to be like the party guy. It's like a good town to be like
yeah.
a party guy.
I
well,
fuck
he's
with
from
Jelly.
Out here, but.
Yeah,
you know,
I fuck with Jelly too because he's like one of those independent artists. We were joking earlier about the country artist stuff because that stuff's real. But he's like an independent guy, so he's done it all with his group, with his team.
Yeah, it's crazy. And I think he's getting money now, right?
Seems like it.
I think he's getting paid now.
Try not to look at his pockets. You try never to look at another man's
I'm
pockets.
I'm always looking at another man's yeah. pockets. I can't stop
I'm always
looking
sneaking
at another.
A little peek.
We interrupt this episode to shout out the boys at Georgia Boot. Head over to georgiaboot.com. Oh, that's for on screen. Georgia Boot, the world's most comfortable boot. Georgia Boot is America's hardest working boot. And for over 80 years, Georgia's been making boots that work as hard as you do. Tough enough for your job, cool enough for everything else. The boys like looking good. Even when we're all working, JP, he's back there. He's got boots on. Boss, he's got boots on. Alex, he's got boots on. All the boys got boots on because it holds up in any condition and it doesn't sacrifice any comfort or style. It has the comfort technology of an athletic shoe packed into a great looking boot. So great looking. They're also at a price that you can afford. Every time I'm wearing these boots, people are always asking, hey, Con, where can I get them boots? I'll tell you right here in a second, because whether you're working on your feet all day, working around the house, or grilling out with your boys, these boots won't sacrifice comfort or style. Said that already. They got the best work boots, wedges, loggers, whether it's waterproof boots, steel toe, soft toe, square toe, Met Guard, non-puncture shank, non-slip sole. The boys got it all. Head over to georgiaboot.com and use code BUSSIN for 20% off. That's BUSSIN for a very encouraging and very generous 20% off.
Just a little curious.
I want to focus a little bit more on Sas. We've been wheeling and dealing. I want to know, like, what's the deal? What's the story?
Get to the bottom of him.
Yeah.
About what? Just me?
How'd you get the Barstool? Like, tell me a little bit. Where are you from? What's your actual fucking name?
Harry.
You're lying. I want to see your license.
It's Harry. You can ask Rone. Rone, is that my name?
I'm not going to ask Rone either.
It's not Harry.
Let me just see your license.
I don't have my license on me.
Yeah, you do because you flew.
I swear to God.
Flew.
I swear to God, it's in the car.
It's not Harry.
Should we read an ad? And while we're reading an ad, you go fucking get
his
in the car?
It's Walter.
I literally, like, it is.
Show him your vax card.
Yeah, I know you got your vax card on your phone.
Can't go anywhere without your vax card.
Here, there's my plane ticket from today. Don't say my last name though.
It's because it's that good.
Okay.
But he's
is it really fucking Harry?
Yes.
Not that I'm making fun of that. That just threw me for a loop.
Yeah, that is my real name.
Why don't you believe that it's Harry? Because a Sasquatch
I just
is Harry?
I just don't trust him.
Yeah.
No one believes when I say that.
He's just got that look. You just don't trust him. Like, hey, what's your name? Harry? Like, you're fucking lying.
Yeah, get to the bottom of it.
Yeah,
man.
How'd you get to Barstool? How old are you?
20.
So you can't drink yet?
No.
All right. Go to the good spots on that.
Yeah, so I got hired at Barstool a little bit over a year ago. Right? Yeah. Year and a couple months.
Okay.
And I'd been on Twitter for like a long time. I've been doing stuff online for like 6 years. And then basically I was in college as a freshman, and then I got sent home for COVID. And then Gaz reached out to me.
Was Gaz the scout? Is he the one in the front office responsible for the hiring of Lil Sasquatch?
Yes, he is.
I thought that KB was the scout. I think KB might have scouted, like Event scouted him, and then he kicked it up to Gaz.
No.
Okay.
No, me and KB knew each other. And Gaz was like, do you know anyone who would like be a good fit at Barstool? And he was like, I can think of one person, but he hates Barstool. And it was me.
Did you hate Barstool?
I mean, not really, but like a little bit.
Barstool was probably used for like bits on like just chirping them.
Yeah, exactly. And so then it was a long process after that. I mean, the process could have gone better on Gaz's end. He'd be like, all right, we'll get back to you. We'll get back to you. Like he was like, hey, do you want this job at Barstool? Blah, blah, blah. We like met. And I was like, yeah, this sounds awesome. And he's like, all right, we'll talk to you at the end of the week. A month goes by, nothing. And I would text Gaz. He'd be like, hey man, hate to bother you trying, cause I'm like, I don't want to say the wrong thing and like not get the job. So I'd be like super careful and have like my parents helping me word out this text, like asking what's going on. And then he'd be like, yeah, things are just a little tricky with COVID right now. I think it was after like 4 months that they hired me.
Of you just waiting?
Yeah. Cause it was in April to June was when I got hired. April 4th, I think, was the day that they reached out to me.
So that's 2 months?
That's 2 months.
Yeah, that's all right.
he didn't finish college. So
yeah, that's what I'm saying. He's a dropout.
So it was 2 months.
Like a junior, senior year of college.
It was two months. And then I did, I worked remote for the first like 2 months and then, or whoever, maybe a month. I don't know. Until August, I moved.
Okay.
Yeah.
How are you wording these texts with your parents? Are you like, hey man, just checking in. You know, I got a lot of stuff on the line. You know, I'm trying to decide.
I did
right
say
now.
That at one point.
Yeah.
The thing was, I had to decide if I was going to go back to college or not.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, as of right now, I'm still enrolled in college. Like, I'm going back in the fall. But I'm like, if I'm going to go full time at this company, like, I'm not going to go back to college.
Yeah. So you're full time with the company now? No college?
Yes, no college.
You going to finish school?
No.
All comedy?
Yeah, I suppose.
Hard knocks.
I mean, like, when you think about it, it's like what I was going to school for would be like, the end goal is to get to where I am right now. So it's like, why would I waste all the money on college? Like, the end goal is to get a job writing somewhere. I wanted to be a writer. And now I work at a writing company.
You could pay $40,000 a year to go to college or get paid the $15,000 Barstool paying you.
Exactly. Exactly.
It's the dream.
Dude, yeah, and I've been here ever since.
But you get to, I mean, do you write for other people other than yourself?
No.
Okay.
That's a legit question, though. Like, being a writer,
he's like, I wanted to go for writing. And it seemed like you wanted to be behind the curtain. But now it seems like you're like doing all your own funny shit.
Oh yeah. I still ideally, eventually I'd just like to be behind the curtain.
Really?
Yeah. Like maybe like
you just
once
said
I've made,
you
once I've made my
events,
millions.
You said you want to be live. Like hear the applause. Hear the Sasquatch King of New York.
Yeah. I'm like,
but preferably you'd like to be behind the curtain.
He's going to be like Daft Punk of comedy. He's going to be just wearing like a bubble helmet or some
exactly,
shit like that.
Exactly. I mean, I would like to be a writer, but like writing, like writers for like shows and stuff, I don't think they really do that well. So it's like not very realistic of a career.
I think writers for shows do decently well.
But it probably depends on the show.
Yeah. I mean, there's so many shows.
I wrote for like a show that it was like a TBS show, but it was like it was an entry level writing position and they were giving me like $3,000 plus a week. And that's like the lowest level like that they can give you, which that's not like bad pay at all.
No.
It's just sit in a room and like eat snacks and like kick around joke ideas. It's like kind of an easy profession.
Yeah.
if you could just crack enough jokes, you know what I mean? It's a fun little gig. So why would you, I don't know why you would go back behind the scenes though. Like, I feel like you're like in front of the camera, you're making money. I feel like everybody who's behind the scenes wants to get in front of the camera.
Yeah, I don't know.
I feel like you'll juggle it. I feel like you'll continue to do all your stuff, and there'll be a point to where you and whatever group wants to come together and you're like, yo, I got this idea. I want to, if Barstool ends up making some like, you know, sitcom or some shit like that. I mean, it sounds funny, but that's not out of the question the way Barstool is kind of going everywhere.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, it's,
I think
like,
it's very
hey,
much within the question.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, there could be a sitcom that you're like, yeah, I want to be a writer on this. Now, you probably play a little role, but.
Yeah. Yeah. I would love to do that. Something like that. I write my own sketches and stuff, but it's like, that's like, I mean, that's just like on a notes pad, like writing down one liners. Like, it's not that. It's like not very like I've been doing it for so long, it kind of gets boring after a while. So I would like to like do like real like sketches, like quality produced sketches.
Like in a script writing
in
type
a scripted
of thing.
Way. Yeah. Like write out a full script
with
for
personalities
them.
From Barstool.
Maybe. Bussin maybe not. Bussin with the Boys. Yeah. We could work you guys
get
in.
Into the script game or into
I wouldn't mind doing
skits.
I love doing that stuff before Vine got shut and I was on my way.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
You were on Vine?
Yeah, bro. Heavy.
I had to
stop because I was too nervous when I went to the Washington football team.
No
way. I was
way.
Like, man, if anybody catches wind of me doing these little. I mean, I was just goofy on it. But
yeah,
I,
what
I
were you doing?
I enjoyed doing just like funny stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. I was a Vine guy. Were you a Vine guy too?
Yeah. Well, I didn't make Vines, but I was heavily
too young
on
for
Vine.
No. You were heavily on Vine?
Oh, yeah. I was in like, I think it came out probably when I was in like sixth grade.
He was heavy on the internet early, though. He was like,
yeah. And then I think it ended when I was in ninth grade,
which is just
yeah,
crazy.
That was a bummer, dude.
Crazy that it
was it a bummer, though?
Yeah,
I think so.
That shit was on its way out for a while. There was like no one was even making videos anymore the whole last year. And then,
yeah,
and then as soon as it was going to end, everyone was like, no, don't take away Vine.
Well, what happened, Vine was on the come up because all you had to do was put in the hashtag and you knew you were going to get those kinds of numbies.
Yeah.
And then they went, yeah, numbies, dude. And then they went with the categories and you could get lost in the equation, dude, get lost in the algorithm.
Yeah.
So I got shunned by it.
I miss like the revines too. Like, you know, you could retweet on that thing on Vine.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like TikTok, it's like you only get what you're presented with.
Yeah, TikTok. I'm
not on TikTok.
Not for you?
It's so tough, man.
It sucks. No,
it would be for me if I was younger, but I feel like I'm doing all the different stuff and it's just another social media you have to put.
Oh, it's genuinely a bad app.
Yeah.
It genuinely sucks.
Because it works so well on you because you just like drop in and like 20 hours later.
I literally
later
think that they should
phone.
Ban it.
Why is that?
No, I hate it with a passion. Everything I see on it like it ruins my day.
But your algorithm is tailored to the things that you like. So it's like you like stuff that you hate, basically.
Like, yeah, I just get sucked in on like comments and I'm like fighting with like 12-year-old kids behind burner accounts on TikTok at like 4 a.m.
But you should just not argue with those people. Like the stuff,
they're
my
so
TikTok
stupid,
experience
though.
Is so pleasurable. I just like see like soccer highlights and shit like that.
I haven't seen
awesome.
Like a normal video on TikTok in forever.
See, I open it and it's just loud from the get-go. I can't like, it can't be silenced. And I'm like, what am I doing? Then I'll just basically recycle whatever I've put a couple times on Instagram.
It has to be like, messing with our brain chemistry the way that it gives
it's
you
it's probably
such
fucking people's
fast,
attention span.
Yeah, your attention spans 100%. Are definitely like crumbling because you get gratification as fast as you want it. And like the algorithm will just sift through till it gives you something that you do find gratifying.
My little sisters, I have two little sisters and they're like, one of them's a junior in high school and one of them is in eighth grade. And they're like, so like, especially the eighth grade one is like the prime, like TikTok. Like their whole, that's like their life
the generation,
is TikTok.
The TikTok generation.
Like all they do is TikTok. And I literally think that they're like getting progressively dumber and their attention spans are just like shot. Like
you watch them and feel bad for them.
No, no. We were watching Shawshank Redemption. This was like in the beginning of quarantine. We were watching Shawshank Redemption as a family. And I'm like, this is like one of the best movies of all time. My little sister's clocked out within the first like 15 seconds. She's like, this is so boring.
Just get
and
out
then,
of jail
and
or
just,
stay in jail. Quit
and then just goes right
on.
Back to TikTok.
Dude, but it might be a dude movie. Shawshank Redemption might be a guy
come
movie.
Come on, man. Like,
it might be a guy movie.
Shawshank's an everyone like, movie. Yeah.
No, I think it might be a guy movie.
No
I'm
way.
Not saying it definitely is, but like there are definitely girl and guy movies. And there's movies that guys are just like drooling over that girls are like, nah, not really for me. and it's not like monolithic. It's not across the board. But I think that there's some movies like there. I don't think women love prison movies.
How am I crazy could they for not? Thinking that? I don't think anyone loves prison movies.
The other side, like you make a decent point, but
I'm into prison movies. Try it with
it's
like,
literally like
Love Actually with them and see if their attention span's really shot.
It's a good movie.
That's a good movie.
It is, exactly. Yeah.
That's an everyone movie.
It's an everyone.
That's a women movie. But it's a women movie that you guys are big enough that you can appreciate. You don't think Love Actually is made for ladies?
No, I can't argue that because my wife put me on that for Christmas.
Yeah, she definitely did.
No, Love Actually is an everyone movie.
Yeah, after watching it, I'm like, oh, this is an everyone movie. But predominantly, I could see
just
him
like
saying
the cover or the way that it's laid out.
But saying Shawshank is a guy's movie is crazy.
I think it is.
Maybe if it wasn't like the most
any
famous
women
movie ever.
Is there one woman in the movie?
The girl who gets
there's
killed.
There's that chick on the poster.
Yeah, like what women do they have to relate to in Shawshank Redemption? Like what women roles are there in Shawshank Redemption? There's nothing for women in there.
His wife cheating on him.
Yeah, and they're like vilified. Like the women, the only women in there are like the demons of the movie. Like,
she gets killed.
Whose side are you fucking on, Rone?
I know.
I'm on the jail side, bro. They should have locked his ass up.
Oh,
and
wait, isn't
away
there,
the
there might be a woman in the jail.
No.
No, like someone that works at the jail.
You're thinking of the opera music. You're thinking of the only soft thing in the movie.
I think what we're missing, though, is the fact that the family sits down to watch a movie together. And you, who is it? Your eighth grade sister just checks out on the family.
Oh, yeah. Instantly.
Yeah.
Throws her headphones in. And the most annoying part about it is, like, so she's the young one. So we have to, like, we can't watch this because she's here. We can't watch this because she's here. And then we get a movie. And then it's like she checks out within 10 seconds.
Damn. Yeah.
Brutal.
Yeah, that's brutal. What do you think about Dave being on TikTok so much?
I have no words. No, I don't care at all. I mean, he explains it like, and it makes sense what he's doing. I don't really know if I fully believe that's why he's doing it. Like when he's like, I'm going to get this big fan base of kids and then they're going to all grow up and gamble with Barstool. I don't think that's the only reason he's doing it.
That's big brain thinking though. That could be some big brain thinking.
That sounds like something that he came up with to like make it sound better for him that he thought everyone would like eat up.
What do you think? Why do you think he really wants to be on it?
I think he likes being like relevant and like in the eye of what's going on. And it's like the TikTok kids, like the biggest people out right now. So he inserted himself into it.
With the BFFs pod?
Yeah.
What's that dude's name?
Josh Richards.
How old is he?
I think 19.
Sas's age? Probably.
I think he's a little younger than me.
20 by now.
You could take him?
Oh, easily.
Yeah.
Really?
I don't doubt it. Do you see this dude? He's bigger in person.
That'd be one and done.
He is bigger in person. The
legs, dude's built like
legs
a brick shit house.
I would clock him.
What do you mean, like in a 40 time?
All right, boys, the ad you've all been waiting for. Shout out Hooters. No free shout outs. Hooters is the go-to spot for killer wings, ice cold beer, and football season. You guys also know what else. But they have all the big games on the big screens. And it's the only place that has the world famous Hooters girls. They love football just as much as you, and they're better looking than your boys. Hooters has game day specials to keep you hydrated and filled up on your Hooters favorites all season long. If you can't make it to a Hooters for the game, you can still get your Hooters fix at home and save $10 with code Barstool, B-A-R-S-T-O-O-L, when you order online. Again, check them out. Check the girls out, hooters.com/barstool for details.
No, but Sas puts in time at the gym. Sas is dedicated to rebuilding, or not even rebuilding, building his body. He's trying to get big. He's trying to get yoked.
Maybe, but he's built like a Chevy.
You know what? Yeah, he is. He's built to last.
Yeah, dude, durable, dependable. Yeah.
Yes, but I mean, I'm... Any advice you have for him? Like, how can he get big? How should Sas get big? He wants to get big.
You're going
to
be here tomorrow. You're going to be here tomorrow? You trying to hit the gym early?
No, I'm like gymmed out. Well, I'm still working out.
Hey, recovery day tomorrow?
I'm still working out, but I'm not like I did the weights so long, just not really getting to where I want to be. So now I'm just going straight up push-ups every day.
Yeah.
1,000 push-ups a day.
Really?
I'm like, this has to work. Like, science says this has to work.
Yeah. Are you getting your protein?
Oh, yeah.
You getting your macros? You counting them?
No, I refuse to do that. I tried it for like a week and I was like, this is like hell. I was like, I'd rather just look how I look now than ever do this.
Then count.
You hitting your protein shakes?
You have to
shakes?
Like weigh your food and be like, oh, okay, this has 30 grams of fat. We can't eat this. Throw it away.
Is that true? Oh, is that really brutal. What it is?
No.
What is macros?
That's what it is. Yeah. That's literally what it is.
Fats, protein.
But like, how do you
fats,
like,
protein, and carbs?
How do people count that?
You got like break it up into percentages. So like, I think most people do like 33%. Or I was doing like a high protein diet, so I think I did like 33% of fat, 33% carbs, and then whatever else protein.
That dude's about that life.
Yeah, he
that's
is.
That's all I know.
That he was doing.
Well,
the
I've
math.
Tried to do it like multiple times, so I've like researched it, and then every time I try it, I'm like, "Fuck this! I'm like, this is so stupid."
You should be easier on you. Like, you should do something like a lot more simple. Like, okay, what's your body weight?
Like 175 right now.
You take 175 and like times it 1.5, and that's how many grams of protein you should.
Yeah,
eat.
Yeah. No, then, I did that this year.
And then you're just like, okay, I eat, you know, 200 grams of carbs a day, and then 120 grams of fat or something like that. And then you just get an app, and you just log it on the app. You don't get a measure. Be like, I hit all my percentages.
Yeah, yeah, that makes sense.
Are you locked in on that shit?
Not as much anymore.
But you used to be.
I used to for sure.
When were you most locked in on that?
When?
Yeah.
When was I? When I was on Washington. I'd say Washington in my first year on the Titans.
And how come? What like what made years? You like really focus on that? Was someone telling you to do that, or were you like, this is what I need to do to optimize my performance?
It was what I thought I needed to do. I mean, it was what I needed to do in my head. Like, I was just brainwashed. I was obsessed with playing ball. I was obsessed with being like one of the best linebackers. And for me, I was like, all right, what does a Pro Bowl linebacker do on a daily basis? And then I just backtrack it from that and write out the whole process of it.
And is that what they do? Is that what, like, guys who are making the Pro Bowl, are they that meticulous about it? Or was
well,
it just...
Well, the thing is, I feel like they probably have, like, cooks, like chefs and stuff.
Yeah, some people have that for sure.
Really?
Some people are just genetically got it.
Yeah.
That's infuriating.
Yeah.
No, that is infuriating.
It pains me, dude. It pains me when my boy next to me is just crushing it on the field and he's just eating fast food.
Who of linebackers that you've seen or played with that just like have it genetically that you're just like, oh my God, if I was blessed with that dude's genetics.
Zach Brown.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Zach Brown. Yeah, he's a beast.
Yeah, Zach Brown. He was.
Where'd he go? North Carolina?
Yeah, he went to North Carolina. He was like an indoor 60 meter champion.
Oh,
he was like a
fly.
State wrestling champion in high school. Dude was a monster. Didn't really work out. Didn't really work out hard when I was with him on Washington. Wasn't the brightest. And he was just somebody I looked at and I was just like,
put me in
this
that.
Dude's genetics.
Yeah. Put this brain in that.
I'm wearing a gold jacket right now.
Yeah.
On the bus.
Damn. He could just fly around.
Yeah. He was a monster. He was on the Eagles for a second.
Yeah. I remember that. And they cut him. I think yeah, he was making bad decisions.
He was talking shit about Kirk Cousins. And then Kirk Cousins like went ham on him that same week. And then they got rid of him.
People love talking shit on Kirk Cousins.
They do, man.
Does that bother you?
I don't, it's not like I'm in all of his drama, so I just don't know. But yeah, I mean, he's a good dude. Like, Kirk's an awesome dude.
Is he?
High character, all the stuff that you say about somebody that's a good person, but he gets hated on hardcore.
Why do you think that is?
Probably just because the teams he's been on, they haven't won the big game. Like, he doesn't have a Super Bowl. You know what I mean? He hasn't gone deep in the playoffs.
Yeah.
I would say that's pretty much what it is.
I think people have like an interpersonal problem with him, like even just him like going down the hallway and like the way he's like whooping it up after
Booyah.
Games. Yeah, that kind of shit I think rub people the wrong way.
Why do you think so?
I think that people just like want to see like they want something specific out of their quarterback when they're like a little bit goofy or like then they're like playing around. I think that bothers some people sometimes.
Yeah,
Kirk Cousins is he's a football player, Sass. I don't know if you know he's a
I caught on.
Okay, cool.
Yeah,
the context clues or whatever.
Thank you.
But I think that might have something to do with it.
Yeah.
Who knows though? It's not fair. I mean, like. Being at Barstool, from the outside looking in, like there's people who like or dislike certain personalities in Barstool. And I'm just like, why would you ever dislike that person?
Right.
Or like, why would you ever like that person? It's like, I don't see it with Sas.
People dislike you, Sas?
Is that what you were getting at?
No, I'm saying people like him. And I'm like, why? What is he doing?
I got a fair share of haters. Don't we all though?
Yeah. If you don't have any haters, like...
You haven't made it
what's
yet.
What's the lyric?
If you ain't got no haters, you ain't popping.
That's right. Yeah.
How do you deal with your haters, Sas?
Block them.
Do you utilize the block button?
No, I barely block people.
I used to.
What I have been doing though on Instagram, there's this new feature where you can block someone and then you can block every new account that they make. It's like an, it's like you click block. So it's like, if I get a mean comment, I'm like, you're gone forever. Like, I'm not, you can't even make a new account and come to my account.
Yeah.
I'm like, you are literally gone forever.
Your children and your children's children will never be able to comment.
Unless you got like a whole new IP address or something.
Yeah, because I was more so thinking about the accounts that have like, oh, I just made $10 million. I can't believe friends told me I could never do it. Come to my page. I'm just like, I need to get this.
Yeah, usually it just like depends on my mood. Like I rarely block people on Twitter. I mainly never block people on Twitter. But like if I'm just like in a bad mood and I'm like looking at my Instagram DMs and I see something that annoys me, it's just like gone
forever.
You ever fire back at the people?
No, that's because that's what they want. Yeah. I've done it like once. Every time I've done once, it, I end up feeling every time I've done it, I feel like a fucking idiot after. Just I'm like, that's I'm like, they want that. Like, they're probably in their room like howling laughing right now.
That's all what you think. All you their could buddies, come across somebody like buddies JP, with JP's their phone. Like that.
What do you mean?
Troll people, but you're like, you're laughing. Like, if they react to it, you're it's laughing about. Yeah.
You're a troll, JP? Who do you troll? Who are you trolling?
You haven't seen my comments?
I know you're not trolling me. Because I will argue with people in the comments.
Hey, Rone.
J-Hubby34.
Just a subtle plug.
Did he get in my ass?
To me, my favorite part about it is like acting like you have so many haters. Like, I just love... I love talking like there's a storyline going on. Like, we were messing around yesterday, JP, and I was like, people swear I don't grind. And I'm just like, you know, right? So, well, people swear I'm not doing this and that.
Yeah,
like,
that's just funny.
Make shit up in my head.
I love that too, yeah. I love doing shit like that.
People swear.
It's so funny.
They all want to see me fail.
Yeah,
just make it up.
Yeah.
You know, rappers do that all the time when they're like, my teacher said I wouldn't be shit.
Right.
No, they didn't.
Yeah.
Or people are like, oh, I'm self-made. It's just like, yeah, okay, dude. Like, you just done everything on your own. Everyone, nobody thought I'd be standing 10 toes down right now.
There's a whole industry of like self-made people. I was in a self-made TikTok wormhole the other day, and the dude said, he was like, I get up at 3:30 every single day and I do the Wim Hof breathing technique and then I do 170 straight push-ups. You saw that?
Hey, they're laughing because I hit the Wim Hof, dude.
I hit the Wim Hof.
I don't mind the Wim Hof.
I love Wim Hof.
But 170 straight afterwards at 3:30 in the morning? No, you don't.
That's like the Mark Wahlberg schedule.
Yeah. Oh, bro, that shit is funny.
Mark Wahlberg wakes up at 3 a.m. to plays 18 holes of golf. Still dark out.
Did you watch his 18 holes was right in his backyard?
Yeah, and then goes and
he's got like a par 3 like hole in his backyard.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
He must be such a shitty dad.
Did you see his
dad's going to bed? It's 4 p.m.
We just want to have dinner, Dad.
Yeah.
Did you watch his little docuseries on HBO?
No. I like Mark Wahlberg. Yeah, I like
him. Like, he's basically taking people around his whole like entrepreneurial gig. Like, he's a movie guy, he builds businesses, and he's got his sons, like his kids, like building little card businesses and stuff like that.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if he's shitty, he's teaching them to be rich.
Yeah. I mean, I was just saying, must suck, because like I'm pretty sure they literally have like family time, like 1 to 2, like etched in.
Yeah, written in.
It's
the
like
calendar.
If you gotta write in when family time is, I'm assuming it's not going great in that house.
And he definitely produced that docuseries himself,
100%.
And his kids were like acting in it. They probably cried one scene, and he's like, "All right, take two. Let's run that back again."
Do you ever watch the Wahlbergers show?
I think I saw like. Back when it first came out, the first episode.
I think I saw a couple of the first episodes, but it was pretty good.
Yeah.
I liked it.
It's just about Donnie. It's more about Donnie, right?
It's about everyone.
Oh, it's about the whole family.
Yeah. It's like the Kardashians.
Yeah. But Donnie like runs it.
Yeah.
And Donnie acts too, right? Donnie's in like Blue Bloods or some shit like that.
Yeah.
Like,
is that Donnie or is that there's three, right?
I don't know.
There's one who owns the restaurant. And then there's one who's in Blue Bloods, and then there's one who's in...
The one that he was just on. Yeah, Donnie. The one who runs the restaurant is Paul.
Oh, Paul. Oh, fuck.
And Robert?
Donnie's probably who's the one that's the little actor. There's
9 Wahlbergs. Holy
there's 9 of them motherfuckers.
And they're all males? They're all men, or for the most part? Holy shit, though.
Their mom just died very recently.
Sad.
R.I.P.
R.I.P. I've never had a Wahlburgers.
It's bad. Yeah, it's really? Not good.
You went and had one?
Yeah, I grew up shit, in right? Yeah, I grew up in Massachusetts.
Oh, that's right. He's a huge New England.
I actually went to private school for 1 year, and it was in fifth grade. I went to this school called Derby Academy, and
did you hate shit. Your parents for it?
Like, yeah, I was so mad. They thought I had like something wrong with me, but then they just found out that I just hated school. So that was, they like put me on Adderall and all this shit. And the only part I remember from that experience was Mark Wahlberg came to our school to announce the Wahlburgers opening up down the street. What and then the as fuck? A school, we walked down to Wahlburgers.
For what? Like a field trip day.
Yeah.
That's what? Some privileged and it was stuff, ass. Dude.
It's even, that's like privileged and like corporate, like weirdly corporate. Imagine really weird. Like,
did you have to wear a uni?
No, we just had to, we had like a dress code.
What's the dress code? Collared shirt?
Collared shirt, khakis.
Damn.
Just picture a bunch of collared shirts and khakis.
Really, really had a bad time at that school. I broke my arm on the first day of school.
Fuck.
Yeah.
That's why you started working out.
It is.
It had to be. Exactly. He was trying to get a rookie of the year situation, come back for baseball yeah. season and just throw yeah. 90.
Oh, I was running.
Who'd you beat up?
No, it was actually a very like not impressive story. I had a lunchbox that was more of a purse lunchbox. Not actually, but it had like a long.
God damn, this had, is soft. It's had soft like a, every word you say.
It had like a long strap.
He broke his arm on a lunchbox that was a purse.
Well, I didn't know how else to describe it. It was a lunchbox, but the strap was long. Long strap. So that you could like attach to your backpack or something. I don't know. I don't know what it was for. I would carry it and I would fling it around the entire time. And then it was like my first day. And I saw one kid that I recognized from like my homeroom. And I was like, where's the French classroom? Like I remember running to go to French. And he's like, oh, it's over here. And for some reason he was sprinting. I don't even remember. I think he was just like one of those kids who just like runs to class.
His arms behind
yeah.
him.
Yeah. So up. I followed him and I tripped.
You started running behind him?
I tripped over the lunchbox strap and I like catapulted in the air and I landed on my arm.
Oh, did you cry?
No.
Be real.
I swear to God, I didn't cry.
Okay.
I held it together big time. It was my first day, and there's like 100 people surrounding me. And they're like, go get the nurse.
Damn.
Oh, I was the type that ran. Did you guys never run to lunch?
What?
Did you guys run to lunch?
No.
Wasn't a runner. Was you
that,
were a runner?
Was that funny, JP?
You were the type that did run to lunch?
Oh, 100%. And through high school.
What do you mean?
Like, I'm saying you're down one of the hallways, uh-huh. and right when the bell goes off to go to lunch, I'm trying to be first in line. Like, I'm trying to go eat. Just because I'm hungry.
Eat, oh, you're just that
big
hungry.
Big dog's hungry.
Hungry dogs run faster, yeah, too.
Exactly. Yeah. And we're kind of toward the end of the hall, so we'd get out and we'd be, like, running to lunch.
You'd swim run moving to, kids.
Yes. Yes.
Trucking you'd be,
like,
kids.
Spinning, doing stuff. The worst part would be like when you got caught and you'd have to like come back and walk next to the teacher. Yeah. But yeah, I'm always trying to go first. And then when people come through the line, the people who got like the chocolate milks, I'd be like, hey, you want your chocolate milk? And I'll try to gather all the chocolate milks.
No way.
That's yeah. hilarious.
You would hoard them all?
Yeah.
Would you sell them back?
No, I drink.
You were fueling up.
Oh, I thought yeah. you meant you were gathering them all up and then you have to like sell them to the kids.
No, I was stupid. I was just hungry.
That's crazy.
You just wanted all of them. You were counting yeah. macros early.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You needed that
a lot of milk.
Because you know when you say you don't have enough to get a school lunch, you would get a peanut butter sandwich and a chocolate milk. And some kids, you know how high school is. Like some of them kids they don't want to eat. Right. They like go throughout the whole day without eating.
Right,
so
right.
I get that peanut butter sandwich and chocolate milk.
But you were doing a reverse Robin Hood. You were stealing from the underprivileged kids.
These kids couldn't afford real food, and you would take the only food they had.
I was in the same boat though. Like there was a couple of years there. I was just getting PB&Js yeah. and the chocolate milk. Bro. Yeah. So I'm hungry.
Yeah,
yeah.
You know what I mean? PB&J is not that bad. When I for at our school, if you had that, you got. Literally like a piece of Kraft cheese singles.
Yeah.
Just in between two pieces of bread.
Jesus yeah, that's Christ.
Tough. That's, yeah. That's, I mean, that's prison. Like prison. That's, prison. Yeah, that's probably bad. Right I mean, yeah.
We're getting honey dumped in our peanut butter too. So it's getting damn. Stirred up. It kind of tastes sweet. It's packed in, soft bread.
Damn.
What school yeah. did you go to? That sounds incredible.
That sounds awesome. High school, bro.
Damn. That's a public school?
Yeah.
And they're just dumping honey in the fucking public?
Yeah, I think so. There's something in them. Then they make these undercooked cookies, chocolate chip cookies.
Damn.
So you want to stack up on all the chocolate milk.
Some soft ones.
You got peanut butter sandwiches and cookies you got to eat.
Yeah. There was some dark shit happening in our cafeteria.
Really?
But I don't know if I want to say it. Like, do you guys care? I would say it on our podcast. Would you care?
Just say it.
Do you guys not like when people like say things that make
How dark? No one knows what you're about to say.
Yeah, no one knows what you're about to say. Like, there was like a whole N-word or
I'm
something.
I'm not, obviously. But at my school, so the cookies, right? They would make fresh cookies, but they would have like the special needs kids come down to the cafeteria and they'd put them in like an assembly line. And they like, I remember going into the cafeteria in the middle of the day, like before lunch started, and they're literally in an assembly line, like taking the cookies, like wrapping them up and like bringing them
over.
They put them to work in the middle of the day.
Yeah, that's fucked up. Yeah. I wish I wasn't laughing.
It was crazy. The way this
has been built up. Like,
no, well, it was funny.
It was the way it was built up.
Yeah.
The way
it is funny too.
It's funny to make any kind of students like work.
It was crazy. I was mind blown when I saw it.
Yeah, that's.
I was like, "That's happening! Like, that's been going on for this whole time."
Back in the cafeteria, in so the you cafeteria. Couldn't actually see them. You had to kind of like.
No, our the setup, our cafeteria was like, I don't know how to describe it.
But you didn't you also them. Say right, that right. like all the kids in your school like thought that they were like gumshoe journalists or some shit? I feel like that would be like the perfect case for them to like break open.
Put in the school paper.
Yeah, throw it in the school paper, yeah. Expose or something like that, and just like.
I think someone actually might have tried to do that, but I think then they got down there and they were like, no.
They made him work the assembly line.
Yeah.
They threw him on the chain gang.
The elite got him.
Yeah, exactly.
Big corporate got him.
Damn.
That's fucked. It was crazy.
We got to go free the kids.
I know.
We should break into the school and free them.
I know. I'd love to go back to this. Actually, I wouldn't.
All right. We interrupt this episode for another ad read. But first, if you're watching the YouTube right now, please, for the love of God, take a second. Go leave a real comment. Click out of the live chat. Just pause your friend making for a second. Go leave a real comment for the boys. Help the boys push the algorithm. And if you're just listening on audio, say your first, say it's like 6:30 a.m., 6:45 a.m., and you're listening to my voice already, go subscribe, unsubscribe, and resubscribe to the boys. Now, to the ad read, Roback Activewear. You all know Roback. We've been shouting out the boys for a while now. The best fit and best feel in the game. It's football season, the best season of the year, which means it's also hoodie season. It's getting a little chilly out there. And luckily for you guys, Roback has just restocked their performance hoodies. And I'm not kidding when we say these are the absolute softest, highest of qualities of hoodies in the game. The material is out of this world soft, and the stretch is unmatched. Nobody does hoodies like the boys at Roback. Roback also dropped new performance polos, and trust the boys when we say these designs are fresh, perfect for the golf course or a night out with your girl. They scream versatility. JP, who's on a date the other night with this girl, says, "Hey, comp, I'm wearing a Roback polo." Said, "Sweet, man. You don't have to text me that." We've worn these polos hundreds of times, and the collars still look brand spanking new every time, and the fabric is just so soft. Roback's gear is popping up all over the NFL, from our boy Quentin Nelson to the Bengals DN Sam Hubbard. Roback is quickly becoming the go-to activewear around the league. They also have two of the biggest apparel sponsorships in college sports, Notre Dame's Kyle Hamilton and Georgia quarterbacks JT Daniels. Learned that he was a backup over the weekend. That's irrelevant to the ad read, but you know, just putting the facts out there. Officially joining the Roback fam, and also it pops up. It's the go-to wear for the boys at Bussin. You have producer JP Hovey, producer Blas Hernandez, content shooters Garrett Hargis. Just always disrespect his last name, and Jack McPherson. Also the lovely Alex Lagos. Hey, since I said your name, JP. How do you feel about Roback? How do you feel about the Roback gear that we get in a box and that sometimes I don't get to see because they're already stolen and taken and brought home to your family?
First off, for everybody listening, I don't have a family. Second off, you can see me right now. What am I wearing?
Roback. You're wearing a Roback hoodie.
A Roback hoodie.
I love that.
In my trunk, performance polo. In my back seat, hat.
Okay, man.
So I got it all.
Deal of the week.
Deal.
Use code. Hang on. You want to do it?
No.
Use code BUSSIN, BUSSIN, on Roback.com for a generous 20% off your first order. That's spelled RHOBACK.com. 20% off your first order. Do it for the boys.
You guys ever go back to your high school?
No.
Never been back?
I did when I was in college. I did a couple times in college. And then like when I was on Washington, when I'd go back, I'd like train and work out there, but not like go for a school day.
Yeah, yeah. Well, yeah, obviously.
I honestly, truth be told, I'd love to go back for a Thursday of chili and peanut butter sandwich day.
Yeah.
Yes, our breakfast sandwiches were crazy.
I haven't been back to my high school since I graduated. And like when I was I remember when I was in high school, I used to think it was always so weird when like the seniors would graduate and then they like, the kids like that you knew, like I was a junior, the seniors graduate and then you're a senior and they come back like they're fucking like celebrities.
They'll like come lean on the door like, what's up, Mr. Fogarty?
Yeah.
Yeah, just
oh my God, cool. You guys are going to love college. You're going to love it.
It's so much freedom out there. It's incredible in college.
That used to piss me off. I was a little angsty boy, though. Everything would piss me off in high school.
Yeah.
A little firecracker?
Yeah. But I would bury it all deep down.
Yeah.
Yeah. I would never express that to anyone.
Let that shit out on Twitter.
Sas would have just hated me coming back in high school, like playing in Nebraska. Be like, oh, what's up, boys?
Yeah, probably.
Letterman jacket out.
Yeah.
Did a lot of kids from your school wind up playing ball anywhere? Or were you like an anomaly? So when you came back, it was like... The fucking boy has returned. The prodigal son.
It definitely was, right?
Like, I love the compliments. You know.
It wasn't. So yeah, it wasn't. Yeah, like, no,
I thought you were about to refute it.
So I know.
Exactly like that.
I know.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's
yeah.
fucking sick.
So you must be like a king when you go back there.
Like King of Bonterre. King of New York, King of Bonterre.
Well, you're actually the King of Bonterre.
Yeah, it's good. It's
that would be awesome.
Yeah, it does sound awesome.
You pull
awesome.
Up to like a high school football game. Paparazzi's there.
I mean, no, not paparazzi, but you know, kids are, you know,
the school journalists.
Yeah, kids are fired up.
I feel like you, like, that'll be your reality.
No.
100%. Why won't it be? Because your team's football, your football team wasn't all that?
No, we just don't care.
So you're going to be a comedian one day, bro.
Yeah, they're going to love you. Like, you're going to be like one of your, they definitely are.
You know, when you go to, you find
the I didn't like most of the people from my high school.
But these kids aren't going to know that. It's not the same people.
It's not even your high school anymore at this point.
Oh, it's just the whole town.
You're talking about the state.
Yeah. The whole town sucks.
Like, oh, he's from Massachusetts.
Yeah.
And then, even though you weren't close with anybody back in high school, like, when a couple generations down, they're going to be like, oh, he went to this high school.
Yeah.
Who cares about the kids you went to school with?
Definitely. I went back to my
high
school.
They're just going to
be haters. Yeah. The fucking haters who don't want you to succeed. Yeah. That's them,
that's
dude.
True. That's true.
That's them in the flesh. I went back to my high school at a football game, and they're like, give us a fucking speech. Like, speech.
Really?
And they all, like, sat down for me to give a speech.
Yeah, but you're also, like, a Philly. Like, I feel like the Philly guys, like, they all loved you in Philly.
What do you mean?
And you were a beast football player?
Like, I don't think I talk about where I'm from enough for this to happen.
What do you mean?
So much easier for Rone to talk about.
Because Rone is like...
Beast football player? Oh, yeah.
I was incredible.
I was sitting here kind of like getting like tight. Like.
No, I didn't play any football. I fucking suck. But just the fact that I was a terrible athlete. But even to go back, just like having like some success from battle rap. It was before I was even at Barstool. They were just like, give us a fucking speech. They loved it. I like came back and did a concert at my school. And I was like trying to do like regular songs. And I was like, you know what? These kids just want to fucking go nuts. So I have one song that I just did when I was like with my, I would just like, when I'd be sitting around with my boys, like trying to smoke, I would just be like, who got daylighter? Who got daylighter? Who got daylighter? Boy. And then I started doing that and the
like
fucking
some Sean
crowd
Paul
went,
stuff?
It was some Sean Paul. I was like, I got the lighter, fire igniter, I came with the flame. And they were going fucking nuts, dude. It was like they didn't fuck with any of the other music, like the songs I was actually working on. And then I did that song and they were like a fucking full mosh pit, people going crazy. It was a nice, but that was like the last time I've been back for like a show at my high school. I haven't been back since. A conquering
That's awesome.
Hero. It was, that was dope though. That was very cool. I haven't
Seems
been back
like you need
Barstool.
To go back to your high school.
You should. I'm saying, like, they'll love you. It's not going to be the same experience that you had. In fact, you can kind of exercise those demons by getting back in high school.
Face your fears. Face
Knowing
your fears.
The kids in my town and, like, their parents and stuff, I'm probably, like, the enemy of the town.
Don't know that.
He's putting a disgrace to the name of this town.
What have you even done that's disgraceful?
Nothing.
That's
They're crazy.
I mean.
So you're just, this is just something
internal.
We
yes.
need to unpack this.
Get to the bottom of it.
Yeah, we need to unpack this.
You're on
why,
the
do you,
bus.
Why do you feel like it's that way?
You want to lie down on the couch?
Yeah. No, not at all. No, just a lot of the people from my town are like really crazy.
Yeah, but you could just be making this stuff up now.
No, it's like a known thing between me and like the normal people.
A crazy how
so
though.
You wouldn't want to go back because you get clowned by your boys, your normal people friends that you're thinking of.
No, my
like
boys,
counterculture
my boys
friends.
Are my boys. Please. I'm seeing one of my boys after this.
But they were like the goth kids that sat underneath the bleachers and smoked cigarettes. They're like, football's gay.
No, we it actually is kind of true. My buddy that we're gonna see was
on the.
You
make fun
of
football? You cheer football?
No, not football, because football wasn't as big. It was, well, it was actually huge at our school, but lacrosse was like the big one. And we would rip on the lacrosse team pretty hard. And also one of my best friends was on the lacrosse team. So, and we still should, we like, just such a weird school. Like we graduated high school and it was the day of graduation. Everyone smoked cigars on the turf.
That fires me up.
On the field. I loved it. I was like, and I hate shit like that, but I was like, damn, this is awesome. I was like, I'm having a great time doing this, smoking the cigar on the field. Yeah. They're not allowed to smoke cigars. The lacrosse players weren't allowed to because one of the teams from the other town, a couple years back, they were going up against each other in states, and they came over and they took pictures of the lacrosse kids smoking cigars and sent them into like the high school rule book, whatever it is. Yeah. And those kids got suspended from the states
for smoking cigars as high school graduates.
Yeah, yeah.
You're 18 years old.
It's 21 in Massachusetts now.
What the fuck? Yeah.
Damn.
Wow.
That kind of sucks.
Lacrosse is gay.
You were right. Yeah.
You were spot on. Holy shit.
Yeah. And we were like going on a school trip one time and like he wasn't allowed to go because lacrosse. I don't know. It's like they treat it like it's like he's going to the fucking military. It's like, dude, we're like 14.
Yeah.
And there's not even like the trajectory of lacrosse to be like a huge pro sport or anything like that. That's whack.
It's also a boring sport to watch.
I'm sorry, Gary. You're the only lacrosse guy we got. I know nothing about lacrosse.
You don't know the rules, like it's probably boring.
Yeah, you probably don't know the rules.
I played. I laced up. I laced up for like 3 years. I was so bad. I don't know why I played. Still to this day, I ask myself, I'm like, why did I do that? I think it was just everyone else in my town played, so I was like, this is something I'm doing now. And I was.
Do you have
so
like a weird
bad.
Running style? Like,
oh yeah, I'm very unathletic.
Except for quarterback. He could have been a quarterback.
I can throw both. I can throw both ways.
He's ambidextrous. Has anyone ever done that? Has there ever been a quarterback who's just throwing with both hands?
I got a perfect spiral on both arms.
Yeah?
Yeah. I do.
Do we have a ball here?
Get this boy a rock.
I'd love to see it.
Buy this guy a rock. His seven-step drop, bro. His seven-step drop is incredible. His balance, he just feels the pocket. You could just tell his like sense of the pocket. His awareness is off the charts.
Do you guys like... Weird question off topic. Do you guys like these microphones better than the ones at the New York office?
I have no clue. I don't have a whole lot of experience with the ones at the New York office.
I love these. And I wish we had. Yeah, these are the cool ones. These are like sexy. I wish we had these.
There you go, boys.
This
you
whole
got the sexy
setup
ones.
Is sexy.
Yeah,
like everything's sexy
is awesome.
About this. I'm just jealous. From
we got these big ass, like, we got these microphones. They're like probably same size as this, but like the foam part is like this big.
Yeah, it's like a Tom Brokaw mic.
And they smell bad.
Really, does that smell back there, Alex? Does that one smell?
No, this is from people recording before us.
But your guys don't smell.
No, you would know. You don't even have to get that close.
Yeah, no one else even uses
We need our
these.
Own studio. This is awesome. Because it's just like, what? Like you use in that chair every time.
Mm-hmm.
You're the only one that uses that microphone.
Yeah.
Don't have to worry about it stanking.
Right. Taylor sits in that one. Guest sits in that one. It all works out.
It's perfect.
Just farting.
Bloss. We got to shout out Bloss. Bloss set up a lot of this stuff.
Shout out Bloss.
Got all the aesthetics going on, all the lights and lighting and everything.
Shout out Bloss.
Shout out Bloss. He's a good man.
Big shout out to Bloss. Big shout out.
So is this your whole crew right here?
Yeah. It's the boys. The only one we're missing is Taylor. He's at practice right now because he's employed.
That's dope. That's dope.
Yeah.
So do you guys all work for Barstool or no? Or do they work for you?
They work for me.
Fuck
that
yeah.
sounds weird to say. I'm sorry, boys. He's like, hey, easy with that shit, man.
I was curious.
Yeah, yeah, no, when we got found, we were already kind of put together a little bit.
Nice,
so that's how we got in there.
That's awesome.
No, it's dope. They deserve more credit. They did the behind the scenes, because the behind the scenes people at like Barstool headquarters are always getting credit. They're like sneaking onto content, and they're like, you know, zillion beers in their ways into things.
Yeah.
Knows what
you guys
is.
Should take a video of you guys burning a zillion beers shirt. from the warehouse.
Yeah, I'm cool with Dana.
Yeah, so are we.
We are too. Yeah. Well,
it doesn't sound like it.
No, we are.
No, Dana's the boy.
Yeah.
Dana's in Mississippi with Coach Prime. Mm-hmm. And so anytime I'm going down there to see Coach Prime,
I'm chilling with Dana.
Yeah.
They love him down there. They go nuts for Dana down there. He's the man.
Yeah.
Dana's a nice guy.
He kind of snuck his way in front of the camera.
Not even it's like a viable career path. I think that a lot of people at Barstool start behind the scenes and then they make their way onto the scenes. Like Frankie Borelli was Dave's cameraman and now he's a host of Foreplay. I think it's like a viable working your way up. Like it's not even like shade necessarily, but it's like people deserve the credit that they of like the work that they put in, I think. And your boys are putting in some work. They deserve some credit.
Oh yeah, 100%. Shout out all the boys. Do I need to go one by one? JP Hovey.
Nah, that's too much.
Yeah, no, let's do them all.
Do each one of them. Blas Hernandez, Jack McPherson, Garrett Hargis, Alex Lagos.
Legos, I love creative. These names.
Sas doesn't even know the names of the people that work on his shit.
That's not true. My roommate does it.
All this stems back from, it seems like, his younger days, man, his high school days. You got a lot of hate in that heart. You got a lot of anger that you got to exercise.
My roommate Owen produces Son of a Boy Dad.
Right.
Our boy Tyler Miller does the clips for our podcast. And then Jake Malisak does the whole video.
Okay.
And they set up the cameras. That's my team.
You didn't shout out your producer?
I would take a bullet for any of those boys.
Yeah, would you? I would take a bullet for you guys, man.
Likewise. And you didn't shout out the producer.
Oh, so why?
I did shout out the producer, bro.
How'd you guys come up with Son of a Boy Dad?
Sas came up with it, actually.
No, Rone came up with it.
No, we literally just texted back and forth names until like I just sent like 20 names and I was like, this one's making me laugh the most. And so we just ran with it.
Yeah, I think it's got a good flow to it too. I like it. I have no regrets on the name at all. I love the name. People will comment and be like, good pod, brutal name though. When have you ever like decided what like you're not? I love this pod, but I gotta stop listening to it, dude. The name,
the name just pisses me off.
The title of it is just killing me.
Names don't mean anything.
No.
Like the names of books, the names of movies, people's names, like they just don't mean anything. No. Like your name isn't like determinative of like your character as a person or of like how good a fucking movie's gonna be. Actually, the only thing it matters in is restaurants. You could tell how good a restaurant is based on its name. Like if something's like Pub and Kitchen or something
true,
like that.
True.
You're gonna eat some good ass food there. If there's ever an and in a restaurant name, it's gonna be some good ass food.
Okay.
Like Fork and Spoon or some shit like that.
Fork and
it's
knife.
Gonna fucking play. Or like Figs and Berries, that shit's gonna be delicious.
Yeah, that makes sense.
That's a little wisdom. That's something I've learned from being on the road out here.
It is true.
We exclusively go to places with ands or something that has kitchen in the name.
Kitchen's good.
Kitchen.
Dude, if it says kitchen in
you
it.
You gotta try a kitchen sometime, bro. It'll flip your fucking lid. It'll have you going fucking crazy.
How did you guys find each other? Like working together?
So Tinder.
Grindr?
No, the Yak.
But Sas had been working at Barstool for like a year. He had said that he was working on a podcast, like on his own, like trying to do a solo.
Oh no, I tried to, but they were like, no. Like I recorded a pre-episode and they were like, nah. They were like, yeah, I think you should stick to more video stuff. It sucked. It was really bad.
Did it actually suck?
Was it actually bad?
It was me talking. It was like my first week there. I was talking alone in a room.
What would you talk about? What did you say? Or like,
I don't even like want to think about it. Cause it's like, it was so cringy.
Does it give you anxiety?
No. It was so cringy looking back on it.
Yeah.
It's hard to do a podcast when you're the only person in the room.
Yeah, unless you're like
Bill Burr or some shit like
Bill
that.
Bill Burr.
But even he probably has like a producer in his room.
Theo Vaughn.
Theo Vaughn just rambles.
D'Elia.
D'Elia's good at it.
Even though he got canceled last year.
Tim Dillon kind of does it on his own.
Tim Dillon's got his.
Like Ben Shapiro.
Ben
just
Avery.
Talk. Like there's a lot of people who will just like rip through some shit. Brendan Schaub?
Yeah, but he does Below the Belt. He's like talking about, he has topics.
Right.
Like to me, like when I watch D'Elia, like D'Elia is literally like just looking at a camera and going off the cuff.
That shit is crazy.
Doesn't Alex do his by herself sometimes? Alex Cooper?
Yeah, I think.
Yeah, probably. But I think,
are we Alex Cooper fans here?
Oh.
She's the big homie.
Yeah?
She's family to us.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anytime we're like in a pinch or we're like, hey, like Dave and Erica are acting like kind of funny about like putting us in these like 5-star hotels or whatever. Like, what should we say to them? Like, what's the best way to complain? She'll just fly out to New York and she'll just like spend some time with us.
Yeah. She'll take care of it.
Yeah. She's the shit.
Sounds like love, man.
Yeah.
Do you guys have the same relationship with her?
No, we don't know her.
Oh, no?
We just know, like...
We'll get her out here sometime for sure.
Yeah, Bussin with the Boys.
Yeah.
Seems like it would fit.
Yeah.
You know, call her daddy, Bussin with the Boys.
Right, yeah. Boy, dad. It's like we're in the kind of the boy triangle. Boys and dad, you know, boys and dads and...
Son of a boy, dad. Taylor calls himself dad. It's like a self-proclaimed
call her daddy.
Thing.
He calls him daddy.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It all kind of fits together.
Yeah.
We should do like a crossover. We should do like a live, some like a live show.
As you can tell, like I'm always trying to get the Barstool community out here, bro.
Yeah.
Rone's been out here. I didn't even know when I had zillion beers on, like, that it was, he wasn't.
That it was
remember
beef?
I was, the, yeah. that, remember when I said I had him on? Like, he was just blowing up a zillion beers. So I just thought he was like a big Barstool guy, like a big Barstool personality talent.
Right. You thought that because he wanted you to think that.
Yeah. And then he sat on the couch talking about, you know, his journey and how he just kind of started the whole t-shirt thing. And I'm just like, oh, so.
Yeah, he's neglecting his actual work. Yeah, he was supposed to be editing. Like, there's a bunch of unedited footage that's just sitting at his desk because he just is trying to go on.
He's trying to sleep on the couch out in the balcony.
Yeah, he's trying to go on missions. But no, Sas was just Sas. Like, he had been there for like a year. I heard he was doing a podcast, and I was like, let's just try and record something. Like, let's just like try and get in the booth. And like, we recorded a couple, and I was like, oh, this is super easy. Just didn't feel like work, and. Like, all right, we're just going to start putting them out. Just started cranking them out. I mean, Barstool's a big podcast network. That's one of the best ways Barstool can make money, through one of their like 57 podcasts. So it's like, let's get another podcast. Let's throw a podcast on the fire. And it's going well.
And when you guys had the idea, they were just all about it?
Yeah, I think
because when
just
they
sent
shut
them,
you down individually, but.
They shut me down individually because the podcast sucked. Like, it wasn't like a personal thing.
But it might
like,
not
it
was, have sucked. How do you
it
know?
Was genuinely bad.
Who I would like to take
I want
to
hear it.
I think it's wiped. I think I deleted everything from that.
Really?
Yeah.
I want to hear it because it might not have sucked. You might have just had that self-doubt thing that you got going.
I think I was also like super nervous because it was like my first week there. I was like, someone's going to come in when I'm recording.
Yeah. Or just not even come in, but walk by a window.
It's also, it's hard to like make yourself laugh when you're by yourself. Like you feel like a crazy person.
Yeah.
Just sitting there for an hour, like telling jokes to no one.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's insane to like a blank wall.
Yeah.
It's just like an asylum type behavior. It's just like an origin story of a maniac.
Yeah.
Like you're just telling, just cracking jokes to yourself. But, we linked in together. We just like showed it to people. It wasn't even really a question. They were just like,
they were like, yeah, you guys can do it.
Do whatever you want.
It's doing well.
Yeah. It's doing great.
And now I've listened to a couple.
Hell yes, they're fun. I mean, it's just like, it's not like high level comedy. We're just like in there. It should feel like you're just like sitting in and like talking with two of your friends, I think.
Yeah, you guys kind of just go off the cuff.
No plan.
Yeah, for the most part. Sometimes I'll have like a couple things in my head that I'll be like, oh, maybe we could talk about this. But like, usually it's pretty.
You've been writing for the show, bro?
Rone doesn't like when I write.
Do you ever get nervous with Rone because he's like a rap battle and he's always just off the cuff all the time?
No, not at all.
He's not scared.
Sometimes Rone gets going in front of me and I'm sitting here like I can't even keep up with what this dude's saying.
He talks. He's quite the talker. That's the thing too. It's funny because Rone could literally do this podcast with anyone.
What do you mean?
Like, I mean, you could have a conversation with anybody for an hour straight once a week.
I do just
like
have
you
a
good
have,
you
he's
have
saying
good
he feels honored that he you chose
I don't
him.
Think that's what he's saying.
No, I'm just saying like it's I'm saying more is like it's crazy like how Rone is like such like a good conversationalist like
yeah
that's what the fuck I'm talking about yeah. That's the fuck I'm
like when Rone dog. I like I don't know if you guys watch the Yak ever but like if Rone or Big Cat aren't there it turns into like a shit show because they are just like so good at like keeping the show flowing.
Yeah. I'm just a talk. I just talk to it gets or it doesn't really get me in trouble, but I'll just like even talk to strangers and shit like that. Like we went to the Yankees game and like.
Well, that wasn't even talking to strangers. You were harassing them.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It'll get me in trouble sometimes. I was just sitting there with him, Nick, and KB, and I was just like talking shit to strangers or just like getting into like random ball. We were in a ballpark. Everybody's just like on top of each other, and I was just talking to random people, and they're like putting their heads down, like uncomfortable that I was just running my old mouth a little bit too much. So I guess it gets me in trouble, but it's not like I'm getting punched in the face all the fucking time. Just like every now and again.
All right, interesting that we have a Roman ad read after an ad we had earlier from Hooters. But most guys have tried different ways to last longer in bed, but thinking about baseball doesn't always work. The folks at Roman, an online men's health company, they're changing the game with Roman Swipes, the secret to longer lasting sex. saying the Pledge of Allegiance backwards in your head, counting backwards from 10. Don't do those anymore, because now we got you with Roman swipes, because they're clinically proven to make you last way longer in bed. They're effective, easy to use, and fast acting, but don't require a prescription. Roman can ship swipes to you in a discreet unmarked packaging, and each swipes packet is small enough to hide in your wallet for whenever you need it. They're super easy to use. Just ask JP. They're super easy to use. Just take the swipes out of the packet, swipe it on, let it dry, the little boys, and you're good to go. That's it. Go to GetRoman.com/bussin, and you can get your first month of swipes for just $5 when you choose a monthly plan. That's GetRoman.com/bussin. Take care of the boy today. Not you, your other boy. And GetRoman.com/.
Hey, Will, do they still call you Minuteman?
Have you ever been punched in the face?
No, not from talking shit.
Okay. From?
From like getting in fights, like okay. From being in like a fight in like college or like in grade school. But I wouldn't even start the fights. So I would just be like in the, like my boys would be in a fight. And I'd be like, yo,
insert yourself. Oh, sorry, I had to break up this fight.
Yeah, just get in the middle and just get punched in the face. Were you fighting a lot in college?
No.
No?
No, not a big fighter.
No?
No, man.
Dude, the dudes on Penn State's football team, or I ran with dudes on the boxing team at Penn State, and like it would come to like 1 a.m, and like a couple of them would be like, all right, guys, you want to go out and like fight some people? And they would just like, it'd be like very calm and organized. They'd go out for like 15 minutes and like beat the shit out of people and just like come back home.
That's crazy.
Not me, dude. I'm just looking for some laughs, bro.
You're just trying to have a good time?
I'm always looking for a good time.
Really?
When the vibes are bad, I'm just like, I just want to be out of here.
Yeah, you just got to bounce.
Yeah, I don't want to hurt nobody. You know what I mean?
That's,
who knows? Who knows what comes up out of me?
Sas is always saying shit like that. He doesn't want to unleash.
Yeah, no, I've never been in a fight. I've tried to fight one of my friends twice.
You did?
Yeah, like my best friend.
Really?
The one here?
No, different one.
I was going to say, we could
set something
line
up.
It up.
Yeah.
Set something up.
He can be really, like, you know, some people can just be annoying as fuck sometimes.
Yeah.
Sometimes you got to lay it down.
What was the context of it?
I don't even remember.
He was being annoying as fuck.
He was being annoying, and then I tried to fight him.
You have to remember.
I genuinely don't.
Like, what triggered you to be like, hey, it's fucking time?
I think he was talking shit.
Why'd you get to where you took your shirt off and ready to go?
Oh, I didn't take my shirt off.
You were flexing your nipples at him?
Though. I gave him a shove, and he backed down.
It's always funny how that works, too. Just give a good shove. Right when you shove, too, like hoping in your head like somebody grabs you.
Yeah.
Like, man, I hope somebody fucking grabs me.
That's
right
the
now.
Hope of the shover, that yeah. It just like ends right there, yeah. That it ends at the shove.
Yeah.
And you were successful both times. I think I could be the annoying friend sometimes. My friend did. He didn't punch me in the face, but he would gut punch me. And he would even threaten. He'd be like, you keep on being annoying. My friend Mike, he was like, I'm going to...
Which Mike?
Yeah, I have a lot of friends named Mike. The one whose house we went to and watched the Eagles game.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He would gut punch me. And I think it happened twice where he would gut punch the fuck out of me and just fold me over like Houdini. And fucking. But it's better than punching somebody in the face. It's just
is
like.
Is it though?
I think so. You're not going to leave a mark. Just kind of get your point across. Just a hearty gut punch.
Mark Wahlberg says a body shot's much more powerful than a head shot.
Does he say that?
He does.
He came to your grade school?
No, he said. In the fighter. Head body, head body.
He gave a speech
head
to the
body,
kids.
Head body, head body.
Before he took everybody to Wahlburgers.
But I also would rather be punched in the gut.
Yeah, fuck yeah. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I don't want nothing to happen.
You don't
want to
be walking around, yeah, broken jaw. Oh,
fuck yeah.
No. Actually,
chip tooth.
My nose is permanently fucking wonky because I got punched in the face in a pickup football game when I was like 15 or 16 years old. Kid named Kevin Ruff, that son of a bitch.
What'd you do to him?
Let's destroy his life.
I fucking the week before we had like a weekly weekly football game, and the numbers were uneven the week before, so we were switching people on and off, and I was on the sideline. Someone threw an interception, and someone on this kid's team was like running down the sideline, and I came off the sideline and I speared the kid. It was like the perfect
you came
form.
Off the sideline.
I came off the sideline and I like scooped him behind. It was the most perfect form tackle. I didn't feel a thing. Yeah. He was fucked up
sweet
from
spot.
It. Exactly. And so the next week, like, we ran the game back. It was like our town versus their town.
Were you on the sideline again?
Yeah. And he like, no, I was like running down, like trying to throw a block on a screenplay. And like, he just like fucking just like climbed the elevator and fucking punched me square in my face. I was bleeding all over the place. Like, my eyes like were welling up. Like, I was like, I'm not fucking crying, dude.
That's crazy.
Just got punched in the face, dude. I'm not fucking crying. And he's like, that's what we do in fucking Havertown. We knock motherfuckers out.
That's wild.
I think he got addicted to heroin later in life or something like that. So I won out in the long run, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, shit, dude.
That's crazy.
Always you guys got fun. Anything you want to ask him?
I got
old,
huh?
How old are you? I'm 33.
Oh, we're in the same realm.
Hell yeah, 32. Brother.
I got married around the same time.
Yeah. Oh yeah, congratulations.
Yeah,
dude.
Both married this summer.
Yeah.
Went on some honeymoons.
I didn't even know you had a gal.
Yeah, man. She's coming down this weekend.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna.
You gonna show her the town?
Yeah, I'm gonna try to.
Yeah.
Get her some hot chicken, just have her shit in bricks. Just make it real painful for her.
Yeah, we're newlyweds and everything, dude.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Tell me what you hate most about it.
It's not like we've been together for a while, so it's like it's not that different, honestly. Like, it's not like this like massive threshold that you cross through where like your life is like so fucking different now. So it hasn't been this massive, like, I guess just like the kind of letdown of like you're planning for a wedding for so long, like every single detail is like, fuck, like, what am I about to plan now? Like, what am I going to like focus on now? Were you real involved in planning your wedding?
I tried my best not to be.
Yeah. You tried to stay out of it.
I tried to stay out of it.
Yeah.
But I try to say my yes and no's when questions were asked.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm just kind of like, babe, like, cause for me, it's all like, we're going to have the best time ever, no matter like what color the fork is.
Yes,
you know what I mean? What 100%. Color the silverware, the plates,
or it's like what shade of white this napkin is. It's like there's a million shades of white of napkins.
I feel like they stress way more about it than we do. We're just like, yeah, let's just have a banger. My things was, I wanted her to have the best day ever, and I wanted the party to be awesome afterwards. And they were accomplished.
Checked them both off. That's how I feel too.
But leading up to it, in my brain, I'm just like, it's going to work out. It's going to be all right. Like, this is going to be awesome no matter what.
Yeah.
Like, no matter if you trip and fall, like walking down the aisle, no matter if something doesn't go the right way, like, weddings are just a great time, depending on the people you invite.
And my main thing going into it was like, those 24 hours are going to pass the same as any 24 hours. So it's like, you still have to just have that day be like a day no matter what. Like, you can't sacrifice every day before that and make every day shitty leading up to it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, just for one day. Like, you have to really maximize that day no matter what.
Yeah.
But it's fun. I have no qualms with it. I think that there's like...
Let me see how this goes, and I'll give it a couple months. Yeah. My thing was like, because people always ask, right? People are always like, yeah, hey, what's different? How's it changed? And I feel like for me, it's just like, I guess when I'm done with my days or I'm going to go do something, I think to myself, oh, what can I bring home? Or like, what can I go get for us?
Yeah.
And I wasn't doing that before.
Maybe, so you're hunter-gathering
maybe
gathering now?
Maybe I'm better now than I was.
Yeah.
But I feel like I have her in mind when I'm thinking of doing more stuff around the town.
Yeah. What kind of shit are you bringing home?
Like groceries, like, oh, let me put on my husband hat, and like, let me go bring a bag home.
Oh, fuck, you know what I mean? You're domesticated.
Yeah. Hit turn up truck down the road. Hey, babe, what do you want me to bring home today?
Hell
do I need
yes.
to get anything? What do we want for dinner?
Yes.
I feel like I'm cooking a little bit more.
Yeah. I respect that.
Yeah.
I'm trying to be cooking more, but in New
now
York,
I wear the fucking
tough,
pants.
Man.
I want that to be clear. I want that to be clear, boys.
You cook because you want to
cook.
Yeah,
I cook because I don't want to fucking cook, dude.
Trying to build a craft.
Yeah.
Maybe open a restaurant sometime
exactly.
where you're the executive chef.
Yes.
Yeah. No, that's fire. I think guys are scared of marriage across the board. I think it's not always on like a super conscious level, but I think that dudes are a little bit wary of it, and I don't think necessarily they need to be as wary as they are. I know I was
100%,
a little trepidation.
That. Yeah.
And it's not scary.
No, not at all.
You're
I just feel like that's just
shit.
A dude thing to think about. Like, we're wild animals, dude.
Yeah.
No one's going to tie us down forever.
When we get pussy forever.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, exactly.
My seed needs to be everywhere. I can't be held down. But
yes,
are you guys trying to have a little one soon?
We're trying to get some traveling in first. I want to try and get some because from all accounts, it's a little bit harder to travel once you got someone else to worry about. So we're gonna try and knock out a bunch of traveling in this next year or so, and then plan it out from there.
Yeah,
but it's definitely eventually in the plans for sure.
Yeah, I'm a homebody, so I was trying to knock her up right away so we didn't have to
really
go anywhere. Yeah.
Oh yeah, 100%. And you are. Yo, let's go.
Yeah. We're having a baby girl. I'm not upset about it.
Huh? Wait, say that whole sentence again.
I said, we're having a baby girl. I'm not upset about it.
That's fantastic, dude.
I was shooting for congrats. A guy. You know what I'm saying? I was shooting for a son of a boy.
For the pod. Yeah. It would've been good. I mean, it would have been good promotion, but.
Yeah, 100%.
That's okay.
I was looking for. I'm always looking for that.
That's okay.
But no, we're fired up, dude.
That's going to be incredible.
I was always nervous because I knew she was going to be like ovulating that week, right? I know we're getting into something you don't even know about. You're still a virgin.
It's facts, though.
Yeah, he's not married.
He talks about it all the time. Hey. I was like, damn, I'm trying to get married so I can fuck.
Yeah. Harry's saving himself, dude. Yeah, and I was nervous because when she told me she was pregnant, I'm thinking like, man, I hope none of the boys got in on wedding night because you're messed up on wedding night. So I'm looking like quality of sperm when you're drunk. Does it go down? Like, I'm not trying to, you know, I'm not trying to risk.
And what did you find?
Is that a real thing?
Yeah, the quality of your sperm goes down when you're drunk. So I'm thinking in my head, like, I hope none of the troops came in from that night because I don't want them to be like, you
they're
know,
shit-faced soldiers.
Yeah, like dumb or something like that.
Yeah. Yes, dude. They're just like stumbling in the door egg just like, what
they're just
the
ignorant.
Fuck?
They're, you know, they just
like going through the fridge of the egg.
Not athletic. No disrespect.
But it's facts, though. That's your least athletic ones. You need to go like fresh out of the gym.
I know. That's what I'm saying.
Fresh at like when
everybody. So we'll give it about 18 years and we'll figure out where we are.
Yeah.
You were really Googling if that's a thing.
Oh, I Googled sperm quality on.
That's hilarious.
It definitely is. Drunk. It's a real thing.
Were you like freaking out for a little bit?
No. My hesitation says it all. Every dude.
You're like, fuck.
I feel like every jockish, like, athlete dude, like, wants a son. They want, like, their, you know, a replica of themselves.
Yeah.
So I'm like trying to get the boy and I'm trying to figure out how do you get a boy. Like I'm searching all that stuff. And so then when she said she was pregnant, I'm still thinking, oh, I'm getting a boy because I'm trying to do law of attraction. I'm trying to put it in the universe.
Yeah.
Manifest it.
Yeah. I'm trying to manifest this shit.
Manifest
this shit, dude. And so I'm like, oh, that's awesome. And I'm like, when do you think it happened? She's like, oh, probably the honeymoon and stuff. And I'm like, you don't think it was like wedding night or nothing like that, right? Like, no, what do you think then? I'm like, babe, I was sauced on wedding night. I don't even remember what we were doing.
I don't even remember coming.
Yeah. You know, I
can't blame me for that.
Yeah. Because it's like you lose track. You're dropping troops in every night and you're trying to figure out like when this might have happened.
Yeah.
And you just, you know, you want the.
Yeah, I saying dropping troops,
dropping
troops, like is Normandy. The funniest thing I've heard.
We're storming the beaches of Bora Bora,
and you want them to be strong. You want them to be smart. I'm playing Baby Einstein CDs by my nuts while I sleep. Just I'm just trying to get them. Like I'm reading them The Art of War on audio tape just to fucking see to build some fucking strong ass troops.
Yeah,
I want the troops to be swinging in there.
I like that too, because now that we get into pregnancy, I'll probably start doing that next to her belly.
Yes,
like, we
got to get going. Why not?
We son need of a boy savage. Dad. Yeah. Well, she's a girl.
She can still listen.
Of a boy dad.
She can
You're
listen
a to the son podcast. Of a boy dad.
I'm a son of a boy dad for sure, 100%.
All males are.
No, play some son of a boy dad for the baby.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Play your jokes. I can play your stand up.
Yeah.
Get her going on homeless people right away. We got to say, I don't know what I'm saying about homeless people who haven't listened to his stand up. It's joking. He said he was kidding right after.
Was
right
I after kidding? The joke.
Yeah, were you kidding? That's the thing.
No, I was.
No, we do.
We're no, doing, I was kidding.
We're doing a live show at a homeless shelter.
Yeah.
Should be love.
Cost $40 a ticket.
So they better be panhandling. They better be grinding those. That
oh my god, dude! Be hey, that was funny as fuck, man.
For sure. But when's your guys' due date?
March 27th.
I love how people say
you're awfully close to my birthday.
Yeah,
yeah.
If we could all be so lucky, when's your birthday?
April 5th.
Wow. Never know, man.
Yeah,
Aries.
Yep.
Maybe Harriet might be in the might be one of the names.
Yeah. Harriet.
Or Harriet. Yeah, Harriet. You don't like Harriet as a name?
No.
After you.
Show some respect for Tubman, bro.
Yeah.
It has to be Harry. Like Harry Potter.
It's a woman. It's a young woman. It's a girl.
You got to get son of a boy dad out of your brain.
Okay. Yeah,
there's
we'll release a one of one son of a girl dad merch for you.
No, it can't be a son.
Daughter. Wait, what would it
daughter
be?
Daughter of a girl dad.
Daughter of a girl dad?
Yeah.
We'll release it just for you.
I appreciate that. I'll boost it.
One of one. No, there's only gonna be one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
We'll frame it. Or maybe like a sticker.
It'll be an original and we'll sign it too.
Yeah, I would love that.
It's the least
your
we could
actual
do.
First and last name.
Yeah, my actual first and last name.
I don't want Lil Sas on there.
Blur it out though. Smudge it out.
Yeah.
Sure. No, that's exciting.
JP, you had something you wanted to ask?
Oh, I was just gonna ask about Jersey Jerry.
Who's Jersey Jerry?
Dude that came on after Rico thing, the guy
that
brought in.
Oh yeah, all that Rico drama, dude. Yeah. I was a fan of Rico when I was there. When I was on the, was he on the Yak?
Was he on that time?
He was on the betting the show.
Like, yeah. He does Pick Central.
Pick Central. Yeah, correct. He was funny as shit to me.
Yeah, he's super funny.
Yeah, he's very funny.
I think he's very funny.
Yeah, he's talking about icing the cooler. I'm gonna ice the cooler. how far out do you ice the cooler? I was like, what are you talking about? Like, you know, ice the cooler. Like, is it like a day you start icing the cooler a day out? I'm like, no, I just bring a cooler to the gas station, dump ice in it. He's like, no, you gotta ice the cooler.
Yeah. Wait, what? He ices the cooler? That's not a euphemism for something?
I thought that was like code.
No, he's talking about icing the cooler. Like, I guess he freezes the cooler.
Yeah. What? That doesn't make the beers colder.
Hey, I didn't know what he was saying. All I know is it was making me giggle. And he's a funny
hilarious.
Dude. He's talking about playing cornerback in high school. I'm just like, you know, you look at him. Like, this dude playing corner. Like, what kind of talent level we got out there?
He's very territorial, though. He unfollowed me on Twitter because I talked to the dude, Jeff Nadeau, who he doesn't like. So it's like, if you communicate with someone that he doesn't like, he'll cut you off. You're cut. So you're cut. So I'm not blocked, but I'm unfollowed.
I need to stay in his good graces then, because we'll DM back and forth every now and then to each other.
I'll message with him back and forth too. Or like I gave him a cooler. I gave him a cooler as a gift. I gave him a massive. He's probably icing the cooler.
He's probably icing that cooler.
He's probably on ice right now. It's just a small gift, and he's still unfollowed me. It's sad, but it's like a lot of people want to stay in his good graces, and so they'll play scared. You know what I mean? They'll operate out of fear of Rico rather than in confidence of themselves, and I think that's what gets people cut off. But it's a political thing, though. It's a very political. What side do you fall on in the whole Rico Bosco situation, Sas? And pick your words wisely.
I am a writer.
Are you?
Yeah. Oh, you're a writer?
Yeah.
I don't see you on the shirt.
Yeah, wow. I've never seen you wearing anything Rico related.
Are you a writer? I've said multiple times I am a writer.
But you also like Jeff Nadeau.
Like, so that's the thing. Like, I don't dislike Jeff Nadeau.
Right.
Do I have to dislike Jeff Nadeau?
To be a writer? Like, what qualifies as a writer?
See, I like Jeff Nadeau. I like Rico. So, in Rico's world, that's
not okay.
Occam's razor. Yeah, you're cut off.
Okay, well, then I'm going to go into that world, too. I like Jeff Nadeau, and I like Rico.
So okay. You're not a writer.
And I think Jersey Jerry's funny, too.
Yeah. I think all the gambling guys, like...
But there's something else going on. Like, I keep on getting DMs being like, you have to say who... Oh, because the writers want Jersey Jerry to win in Rough and Rowdy. That's why.
Oh, he's the guy fighting the dude.
He's the guy fighting the dude.
Because yeah. I was like, it looks like a Dollar General versus Dollar Tree out there. Does it not, though?
Yeah, it does.
But if you see the bags that they're getting, they could spend a long time at Dollar General and Dollar Tree.
What kind of bags do they get?
Yeah, what are they getting?
I don't know the specifics, but I know what other Rough and Rowdy people have gotten. I think it might be uncouth to say, but they're getting a lot of money.
What, like more than six figures?
I don't know, but...
Huh?
We're counting people's money.
We're just. I'm just asking a question. We're talking six figures. There's a lot of six figures out there.
Okay, so like when Billy won, he got what, 50K or 100?
Probably closer to 50.
Because it's
prize money. And it's more than that. And it's I know it's more than that. Yeah,
Billy football made. It's obviously like the prize taxes and stuff. So it's like I think he won 100K, but I think he probably won.
I think he won 50.
No, I think he was 100. To fight Canseco?
Yeah, I think he got 50. And I think that Canseco got over a million.
Yeah, and then now he took a dive.
I might be speaking out of turn at this point. But
yeah,
then,
taking a dive. He did.
But the price keeps on going up. When are you about to get in that ring?
Is this the final one?
Final ad.
The final ad read coming to you. Interesting. We're doing Sling TV now after doing Roman and Hooters. They got the. If you love watching Skinamax live sports...
Skinamax.
If you love watching live sports, but you're tired of the high prices, it's time to take control of your TV experience. It's time you got Sling. Sling is a place for your favorite sports channels like ESPN, FS1, TNT, and more all come together for less. And it's the cheapest way to get the best NFL viewing experience on TV, NFL Red Zone. With the Sling Blue Plus Sports Extra Package, you get Red Zone, NFL Network, and more for only $21 in your first month. That's less than a dollar a day. Plus, watch past episodes of The Boys, Bussin With The Boys, The Yak, Stool Streams, and Bus Stop Sessions, and Under the Hood of Bussin' With The Boys, exclusive new Barstool content, all for free on the Barstool Sports Channel on Sling. Sling is easy to set up, easy to use, and there's no contracts. Starting at just $35 a month. What's the... Sign up now and get your first month for just $10. Okay, that's where the $21 part comes in, because it's $21 for the first month, $35. Gotcha. All right. Whatever you're into, Sling is where you can find the live sports you love all in one place. Go to sling.com/barstool. That's sling.com/barstool to sign up now and get your first month starting at $10. Rough and Rowdy?
I mean, you see these bags that they're throwing around and you're already in shape. The thing that's the worst for people is getting into shape. Like Billy said, he'd fight in another Rough and Rowdy if it was just next week and he didn't have to live for 2 months and like getting in boxing shape, working on his cardio. What if you just fought somebody?
Yeah, I mean, if the price was right, I'd fight somebody.
For real?
Why not?
Exactly. Why not?
Yeah.
So
when you say for real, that's why I'm like, yeah, why not?
So that's like, a good fight. We could make it happen though. We could make that happen for sure. Who do you want to fight? Do you want to fight like a West Virginia guy? Do you want to fight a guy who works in a coal mine or is like a logger? Or do you want to fight like somebody who's like an internet person? Do you want to fight another football player? Like who's the dude on Washington that looks like you?
Ooh.
Who is that?
Damn, what is
fake
it?
You?
I'm blowing this dude because I hate kind of disrespecting it.
Fake, but yeah, I've seen him only in passing for a stolen valor of you. But
it's not like who I want to fight. It's more of like, yeah, I would fight for money.
Yeah.
So I don't need a cause like.
Yeah, just fight for money.
Yeah. Mayo, David Mayo.
David Mayo, yeah, fight Mayo, man. Make a mayo sandwich, man.
Yeah, I see you. You're a good promoter.
I just think that there's money to be made. And
right.
Like, Pac-Man definitely got a fucking bag, and he's going to come back and get another bag eventually. Probably more than Billy. Definitely six
Two commas
figures.
Or one comma? Three commas.
Probably two. I don't know. Probably just one comma. But like it was good. Like he wants to come back again. He was happy. He lost his fight. And I think he was happy with how it went. So you could tell like he was definitely making money.
Yeah. I wish that one could have went longer, like longer rounds and stuff like that.
I think if they redo it, I think it will.
Yeah.
I think the rematch will be either longer rounds or
Rough
more
and Rowdy's
rounds.
Growing.
It's fucking crushing it right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, it is.
And the names are just going to, like the prices are, like people are making more money. Bigger names are going to be in
you
it.
You should fight Bryce Hall.
Who's Bryce Hall?
TikToker. He said he wanted to fight in Rough
yeah,
and Rowdy.
Yeah, he did. And he's like, he's got how many followers? Like 10 million?
10 million
on TikTok?
No, like
at least
20 million.
20 million on TikTok?
You guys could
like
be
that?
My agents.
Let's get
you
it.
You would beat his ass, too.
Yeah.
He's, like, not that big, and he's also on steroids.
I mean, look
fake
at him.
Muscles.
Yeah, I would love to train for a little bit. Get into boxing.
It's
buy
awesome.
For some cash.
It's, like, a whole different type of
If you were
of
fighting
shape.
Bryce Hall, you'd get a pretty good payout.
Six. You guys are my agents. Hey,
let's,
you guys
let's
are my
make it
agents.
Happen.
You
let's
guys are
make
my
it
agents.
Happen. I'm going to talk to... I'll talk to somebody today. I'll talk to somebody about it. I'll talk to... So Devlin is newly in a role where he runs. This guy, Devlin, who... he used to do like a lot of the...
Oh, yeah. We met Devlin.
Yeah. He's the man. And he runs Rough and Rowdy now, basically. Especially like the planning it. Like, he's always looking for fights. Like,
yeah, and if anyone brought him a fight, he'd be like, oh, yeah, we'll make it happen.
Yeah. He's super into it. And... why not? Like you're it bodes well for Barstool people when they fight in it, especially like if you win, like the people who have won, who have fought in Rough and Rowdy and are still at Barstool, like they're all doing incredible. It's like, it's a good omen if you fight and you win, and you would win.
Yeah, you fought in it, haven't you?
Oh, like five times. I can't stop fighting in Rough and Rowdy. I keep on fucking fighting. We're trying to get Sas on the training.
Are you trying to get into it?
No.
Why not?
Josh Richards.
No, I would never fight.
Yeah, let's beat the shit out of Josh Richards.
Yo, what?
Let me be in your corner.
That would do numbies.
We got Mike Chandler in town. We can go to his, we can train at his gym.
Yes.
No, I'm good.
Why not?
I would never fight in Rough and Rowdy.
For $1 million?
No. I don't want, I don't want to even have the thought of losing a fight.
For $1 million?
So for you, it's the thought of losing a fight. For me, it's just fighting in a Rough and Rowdy. It's like, you know.
It's an incredible.
Not to talk about the demographic, but I'm just.
Yeah. Oh, it's an incredible fucking, like, just doing some West Virginia shit, some country shit. Like, it's an incredible platform for somebody to thrive on. You could even fight against. Come on. They definitely would love you. You should fight Bobby Lang, the dude that Pac-Man fought.
Fight Jake Paul.
Jake Paul.
Hey, we get Jake Paul going. We could get Jake Paul on the line.
Or like, another football player would be, that would be easy. That would be easy to like.
Yeah. I mean, create. At the end of the day, I'll fight for money. So if we could figure something out here.
Let's make it happen.
Yeah.
Let's make it happen. I love this.
By the end of the day.
Yeah.
JP,
really
you think I lose?
I mean, I've seen you hit the bag a couple
times. No, you haven't.
Were you saying he doesn't have any thump?
Hang on.
I'm texting Devlin right now.
Yeah. Shoot him a message.
Just.
Ooh, hey, we get me and Biz.
Ooh.
Oh, that would be a great fight.
Who knows? Who gives a fuck? Right. You guys aren't getting it.
Okay, sure.
Yeah, that would be incredible.
Yeah, yeah, man. Biz versus you would be unreal.
And he's a fighter.
I think
he
I'd
fight.
Sneak up on you guys, dude.
He is a good fighter.
It's crazy that you're doubting me, number one.
He was a professional fighter on skates.
Yeah, on skates.
That's a nice show.
I'm breathing. Hey, that's my Wim Hof. That's my Wim Hof.
You're just breathing. You got a little.
Yeah, you just got a little photo of my belly sticking
out. A little gut to him. Nothing wrong with that, though. Most of the,
how old is Biz now?
38, it says right there. 36, 38, 85, he was born.
36, that's not bad. How old are you?
32.
Oh, 32?
32. I'm a young 32 as well.
Spry, 32.
Is that too much of an age difference?
No, what? No.
Like a lot might change.
There's like he was a hockey fighter, dude.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah,
but like something might like you know his bones are probably brittle.
They could be strong. He could be on his.
He's gonna fight you after that. No, fuck. No, I think that your body starts like you have like tons of recovery like up to 40. Like your recovery is and even after that like look what fucking Tom Brady's doing.
Yeah,
Tom Brady can fucking sling a football. Fucking
yeah.
Can he fight though?
He's at 44 though. He's 32, bro. He could definitely get in that ring.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a really good one.
You I wasn't saying Biz. That he couldn't get in the ring. I was saying I don't know about Biz.
Old man Biz?
Yeah.
Biz is gonna whip your ass.
Biz has gray hairs growing out of his
Biz
beard.
Was getting the ring. Biz was talking about Jake Paul.
Oh yeah, that's true. He was.
And he's a fighter. Like he's fought. He knows how to fight.
Yeah.
That would be fucking great. Have you ever boxed before? Just nope. Hit the bag. You ever do a speed bag or just a heavy bag?
I've just dabbled on a speed bag before. And when I say dabble, like there's a speed bag sitting there and I mess with it.
It's speed bags are hard.
Yeah. What's up?
What's your punching power on that game?
What game?
Where the punching bag like hangs down.
Probably a million. I don't know.
Easily a million. Dude, I think that we could set something up. I texted Devlin, ball's in his court right now. But whenever we start talking about that shit, like the Super Bowl Rough and Rowdy, like if we do it at the Super Bowl, what?
Yeah, but
that would be
fucking I'll probably
sick.
Be in the Super Bowl.
Yeah, exactly.
Whatever team brings me
what
in, like, we're
both?
Going to.
What if you do both, though? No one's ever done that. That'd be like when Dion, like, played a baseball game or, like, a playoff baseball game and then, like, played on Sunday for the Falcons. Like, if you play in the Super Bowl and fight in Rough and Rowdy the same weekend and do a podcast, it's a triple threat.
It definitely sounds nice.
Yes, dude.
It sounds nice on an individual level. But if I'm on a team going to play the Super Bowl, like, you're all ball.
They got to understand you're all that. You got it. Like, whenever you go and
dude,
talk
they
them.
Could all come to Rough and Rowdy. It
would yes. be
going is the Rough and Rowdy after the Super Bowl?
It's before the Super Bowl.
Oh.
When
you won't get really hurt. You'll probably get like you could get like scuffed up in the
it's
face.
More, it's
or
more
something.
Of like
you're gonna be exhausted.
It's more of like, hey, where's your head at?
Yeah.
Like, we're about to play in the Super Bowl.
The one Super Bowl
if it was after the Super Bowl.
Okay, well, if you're going to the Super Bowl, you're probably training pretty hard, right? kill two birds with one stone there. Dude, you can just show up at the fight the day of the fight.
Just don't tell them, and then they just find out on the internet.
Yeah,
yeah. Just sprint out in full uniform.
You don't have to even train if you're training for something else at that point.
That's true.
Jared Goff's boy fought in the one Super Bowl. It was their fantasy football team, their fantasy football league's competition. Whoever lost the fantasy football league had to fight in Rough and Rowdy. And so their buddy lost the fantasy football league, and that same week, just by happenstance, Jared was in the Super Bowl. He didn't show up at the Rough and Rowdy, but it was still like his boy as like it was one of the main event fights of the entire weekend. It's kind of badass.
Yeah,
but Goff didn't show up. That's kind of not a great friend.
No,
not a great friend.
Just get your priorities in line. So you know
what
I mean?
Are you for the boys? Or are you for
right? Exactly.
A game.
For the Rams or whatever. And maybe maybe they beat the Patriots.
Yeah.
If he shows up for his friends, if his priorities are in order. But yeah, I think that's a good goal. That's a good goal to take.
You're my
show.
Agent.
Yes.
Just stay in contact with me.
Yes.
Let me know what Devlin says.
Sas is a top promoter as well. Sas will sell the fuck out of this fight.
There's no question.
He'll get some fucking numbies for you, no doubt in my mind. And we'll make it happen. Let's all get
we'll
rich.
Be a, only if we're allowed to be in your corner.
How many people can I have in the corner?
Unlimited.
Unlimited.
Just yeah. have an entourage.
Pac-Man Jones had maybe like 150 people in his corner.
Oh yeah, we'll go deep. Hey, we'll go deep, boys.
Yeah, fuck yeah.
He, like, you guys will
be in my
hotel.
Corner for sure.
All yes. right,
love it.
Huh?
Yo,
you might be able to put the bus there just for whatever Barca wanted to like
ride out on the bus
for afterwards.
Is this a functioning bus? Towed.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't run.
Push it. We'll push it. Yeah, just have a bunch of strong, big, strong boys. Yes.
Oh, you got to be waving the flag. Like, whatever flag we have, I want you stone faced just waving the flag behind me.
I'm down.
Yeah.
I no, definitely
Sas has to become, you know how they'll have like J Balvin rapping or something like that? Sas has to just be doing his comedy set as you walk out. He's just like telling jokes. Just walking you out. That'd be fire. That'd be incredible. I love
boys,
it.
Boys, we've done an hour 40 on here.
Yeah.
It's been a good episode. I've had a lot of fun.
Strong episode.
I love the studio.
Yeah.
I appreciate it, man.
It's awesome.
Went fast.
You're always welcome.
Thank you. We might have to start flying out here weekly.
Yeah.
Record our episodes here.
Yeah. Just start. Yeah. There you go. You get a real set.
Yeah.
We should. It wouldn't be that.
Just
I mean,
get a son of a boy dad sign.
All we gotta do is switch them out. I would love a glow up sign.
Let's get a glow up.
And then he's in the same scenario doing it on someone else's set.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're the ones who make the mic stink. We got the smell. Yeah, it was us all along. Fuck yeah! No, it's a pleasure to be out here. Thank you so much for having us.
Yeah, thank you. Appreciate
Literally,
it.
Whenever you want to do it.
Yeah, hey, son of a boy, dad, go download, rate 5 stars. You guys know the drill. Comment, subscribe, unsubscribe, resubscribe again. You got to get those boys up to the top of the charts and hack the algorithm,
please. Please.
What are your socials? Lil Sasquatch.
Lil Sasquatch 66.
And. _ Rone on Twitter, Adam Ferrone on Instagram, TikTok. Hit us up.
Shit.
Shit, man. Hit us up, man. Fuck, man. Come on, man.
All right, boys. Anything else?
That's it.